Good morning, good morning, and welcome. Yes, this is your Feel Good Breakfast Show, Espresso on S3. Thank you for choosing us to start your weekend because we are so excited. We've got a jam-packed show for you. Good morning, I am Zoe Brown.
Good morning, Zoe Brown. One of our favourite resident women in this space. Of course, today we do recognise, celebrate, and really take a moment to ponder what it means as we celebrate International Women's Day. So happy Women's Day across the world. But I think take a moment for the women that are very special to you in your workspace, in your environment, at home. Take that moment to show that appreciation because I think often the effort goes very much unnoticed or very much unvalidated. So please do that today. And we're going to have a lot of fun as we do that as well.
Definitely. So today, just to unpack some of the things, we're going to look at the latest findings of working women in South Africa and also what they want and how they are knocking out any stereotypes. And furthermore, we're going to shine the spotlight on women dominating in the gaming space as well as the movie industry. So really putting the spotlight on the ladies.
It's been a massive year of progression, I think, across all sectors, and we want to mark that. And then finally, entertaining us, a three-person group this morning called Soil. They are phenomenal. We cannot wait for you to hear their latest hits. Those beautiful faces are back. We cannot wait to connect with them and connect them to you. It's going to be the perfect start to the weekend. And of course, we've got another perfect friend waiting to celebrate International Women's Day as well. Zanele, I'm sure, is as excited as we are about embracing what must be a vitally important day. So really, really chuffed to be connecting with her this morning as well.
My goodness, you are so perfect, my beautiful Graham and my beautiful Zoe. Good morning, Cape Town family. It's such an incredible thing to be celebrating International Women's Day, especially as we go on into the weekend and silly figgy pleasure for good times, Espresso family. And we're coming to you live from, of course, the Samsung showroom at Design Quarter in Johannesburg. And as you heard, it's going to be an incredible show. So this is why you need to stick around. The perfect start to the weekend indeed. However, we also want to hear from you on the social media streets. So, my friend, it is all about hashtag Espresso Show, as well as those voice notes on 063-408-8863. All in the name of celebrating International Women's Day. And a very happy one to all of my beautiful ladies out there far and wide. We need you to head over to the social media streets and let us know who are the women that inspire you to be a better version of yourself. The ones who honestly and truly allow you to genuinely go out there and be the best version of you. And for me, I can 100% tell you, it's all of the ladies here at the Espresso set, as well as, of course, my mother. Hi, Mom. Hey, Princess Girl. And then, you know, no bias whatsoever. It's our boss, Patience. And that has nothing to do with the fact that you gave me a job. Okay, I'm gonna get emotional now. It's gonna be a happy International Women's Day indeed. And as you can tell, the energy is high. We're ready for you, and we are so in it to give you the Feel Good Breakfast Show that you deserve. But first and foremost, it is the top of the hour. So let's start off with those news headlines with the beautiful Zoe.
Thank you, Zanele. Oh, we are so excited. Well, let's quickly get the show underway by taking a look at our national headlines, starting with local news. The court appearance of four suspects implicated in the disappearance of six-year-old Jocelyn Smith, who went missing more than 2 weeks ago at Saldanha, has been postponed until Wednesday in the Frederenburg Magistrates Court. The accused, which include her mother and boyfriend, will remain in custody until then, when a formal bail application is set to be heard. The suspects, Jacqueline Apollis, Stevino van Rijn, Raquel Chantal Smith and Pumza Sikagwa, face charges of trafficking persons for purposes of exploitation and kidnapping. It's understood that more arrests are likely to follow. And Northwest Province has presented a budget of almost 54 billion rand for the 2024-2025 financial year. The social cluster, consisting of the Health, Education and Human Settlement departments, amongst others, have been allocated more than 42 billion rand, with education receiving the largest chunk, just on 22 billion. And the Western Cape government has tabled a budget of over 250 billion rand for the 2024 medium-term expenditure expenditure framework. The Provincial Minister of Finance and Economic Opportunities, Muriel Wagner, says the poor and the vulnerable are being prioritised. Moving to news beyond our own borders, three West African countries run by military juntas say they will form a joint force to fight jihadist threats. Niger, Mali and Burkina Faso announced the formation of the force following talks in Niamey, capital of Niger. Niger's army chief, Moussa Bamo, announced it would be operational as soon as possible. Groups linked to both the Islamic State and Al-Qaeda have killed thousands of people in the past year in the three countries. The military regimes have strengthened ties with Russia of late. And new figures show that last month was the warmest February ever since records were kept. The European Union's climate service says the average temperatures in the world in February was 1.77 degrees Celsius higher than before the industrial age. A record has been set every month since June last year, and the sea surface temperature is the warmest on record. The concentration of carbon dioxide gas in the atmosphere is the highest in 2 million years. And just picture this, more colossal footprints in the Knysna Forest. No, that's not a mere fantasy. Recent findings from a Sanpark study hint at the potential of resettling more elephants in the Garden Route's Knysna Forest in the Western Cape. Collaborating with scientists and stakeholders, Sanparks carefully weighs the recommendations. The study aligns with the sighting of an elephant cow in the Knysna Forest. Yet stakeholders advocating for resettlement, recognizing its ecological, historical and cultural significance, voice concerns about commercial interests. Experts stress the need for a meticulous management approach involving elephant specialists, landowners and conservation authorities before any relocation. Still, wouldn't it be marvelous to witness more of these majestic animals roaming the Knysna Forest once more? Well, those are the types of questions we like to ask. That's where I leave your headlines. Let's take a first look at your sport.
Thank you so much. So let's start with last night's European footballing action in Liverpool. They delivered a commanding performance, thrashing Sparta Prague 5-1 in their first leg of their tie in the Europa League last 16. And of course, an early penalty by Alexi McAllister setting the tone, and then followed by a Darwin Nunez brace and a goal from Luis Diaz. And despite Sparta's consolation goal and a VAR ruling out Mohamed Salah's effort, it was Dominic Szoboszlai's added fifth goal that sealed it in injury time. So Liverpool now holding a commanding advantage heading into that second leg. Then we turn to rugby and Ireland aiming for a grand slam. Welcome back Hugo Keenan for tomorrow's Six Nations showdown with England at Twickenham. The world-class fullback definitely fit again after a knee issue. He comes in to replace Kieran Fawley in that starting 15. However, Ireland will miss a lock James Ryan for the remainder of the tournament due to a freak bicep injury suffered in training. Can you believe it? So Ryan's absence now extends to next week's finale up against Scotland. Then on to cricket, and on a dominant opening day for India in the fifth test, Kuldeep Yadav's five-wicket haul helping bundle England out for 218. The Yadav's figures, an incredible 5 for 72, supported by Ravi Chandran Ashwin's 4 wickets in his 100th test as well. What a way to mark the milestone. Saw India dismissing the visitors in just 57.4 overs. Then stepped in skipper Rohit Sharma with a 52 and Shubnam Gill with 26, and they remain unbeaten at stumps, with India reaching 135 for one at the very picturesque Dharasamada Stadium, trailing England now by 83 runs. And then on to motorsport, and Fernando Alonso of Aston Martin, he topped yesterday's floodlit second practice for the Saudi Arabian Grand Prix, and that was following Max Verstappen's earlier pace-setting performance. Mercedes' George Russell, he secured second, trailing Alonso by 0.230 seconds. And Verstappen, he settled for third, 0.331 seconds behind Alonso. And that practice session took place at Jeddah's Corniche Circuit, quite a sight, with the race being held a day earlier than usual to coincide with the start of Ramadan on Sunday night, amid a record 24 race season, doing what they can to jam it in, which we love. But quite an auspicious one, this. And that's where we leave our sport for now. We'll touch on those headlines again at around 7 o'clock. It's the foot of the weekend. Let's see what the weather has in store.
Thanks, G-Man. Well, let's take a look at your weather. The SA Weather Service has issued a yellow level 2 warning, and that's for severe thunderstorms, strong damaging wind and heavy downpours that's expected to cause damage to property, blowing off of roofs, as well as flooding of susceptible roads in the western bushveld of Limpopo in the early morning. Disaster teams in all KwaZulu-Natal municipalities likely be affected by the severe thunderstorms. They are on high alert. And the Weather Service has also warned of extremely high fire danger conditions over central parts of both the Free State and the Northern Cape. And lastly, a heat wave with persistent high temperatures that is expected in places over the escarpment of low veld of Limpopo until tomorrow. Hot and humid weather will result in extremely uncomfortable conditions in places over Limpopo and the low veld of Mpumalanga. It is 6 a.m., so let's take a first look at your sunrise view. Boitumelo from Brits is kicking us off with this beautiful view. If you would love to share your view like Boitumelo has, do so on our WhatsApp line. That number is 063-408-8863. But let's take a first look at your temperatures for your Friday.
Some of the temperatures still up there, but some crazy weather, so please take heed of those warnings. And now let's, in honor of our cheesy sub that we're going to make in a moment, let's bring a little bit of cheese and make it rain lots of cash. Now, we know we get excited about Lotto over the weekend because on a Friday it's big, and today we want it to rain cash. In fact, for the rest of March, we have got over 110 million rand in total guaranteed jackpots this weekend. So you've got to do it. Play Powerball for a guaranteed 70 million rand, and then Daily Lotto for a guaranteed 750,000 rand today. And then the excitement doesn't stop there, because you can also play Lotto for a guaranteed 40 million rand tomorrow. This is a combined jackpot of over 110 million rand waiting to be won. I think this is kind of breaking the bank for me. I don't think we've ever been a part of a number that big, to be honest. But as always, if you want to win, you've actually got to play, and you can get your tickets today in store, nationallottery.co.za, online, their mobile app, cell phone banking, or you can simply dial *120*7529# for the USSD. And all of those details, we'll keep them up today and tomorrow on our social media platform, so you can go and check them out for yourself, and then just put yourself in line to win Mega Millions this weekend. A life-changing 110 million rand in total guaranteed Powerball, Daily Lotto and Lotto jackpots waiting to be won. Why should it not be you? Just go ponder, pusher, play. You can ponder those lucky numbers as we ponder the position of women in the workplace and how that landscape is changing dramatically. It's time to smash through that ceiling, however it looks, whether it's glass, concrete, we don't care, because it is International Women's Day and the game is changing. We cannot wait for that panel discussion. And then, of course, yes, we bring in more cheese. We've got a cheesy steak sub to whip up because it's a Friday. We'll see you for that now.
Stand the chance to win a year's tuition bursary with Stadio Higher Education. If you've matriculated but haven't secured a place to study or want to make this the year of your career growth,
well, then WhatsApp the word Stadio to 068-565-4114 and tell us what you'll do once you achieve the degree of your dreams and study with Stadio.
A new vision in higher education. Competition runs 4 to 15 March. T's and C's apply.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back. I think you can feel my excitement this morning as we broach our first topic today, and it's a big one. Our next guest is just amazing. Philippa Geard, founder and CEO of Recruit My Mom. I love it. The company that has brought out the largest report done to date in South Africa around working women. And yes, a significant number of them are moms who keep us propped up. Now, the research surveyed over 2,500 skilled women in South Africa to really interrogate their level of satisfaction in the workplace, the benefits, the work situations they're looking for, where they find themselves, and how businesses can look after these women in their companies, i.e. get the most out of this valuable asset. And she joins us to discuss her very interesting findings and some of the truths that they have revealed. So first of all, Philippa, you're awesome. Thank you for representing this. I think you can see I have a bias towards this particular asset that in my mind in South Africa is completely untapped. We know that our communities are being propped up by women. Some of the biggest foundations I've worked with within the community space say you get four times the amount of return on investment when you invest in a woman. But I think for me, I have to start with the name, Recruit My Mom. So give us a bit of background as to where you're coming from before we delve into the report.
Yeah, sure. So Recruit My Mom was launched in 2012 in South Africa. And it was an answer to a need amongst women who were being overlooked by recruitment agencies. And we knew that employers could tap into this incredible resource if only they knew how to, and the fact that these women might need a different way of working. And that was pre-COVID. Post-COVID, we've had a bit of a shift in the way women want to work. But it really was around this amazing asset group, as you call them, and how do you tap into them to utilize them in this work, you know, in our workforce in South Africa?
And it's so funny because you're speaking post-COVID language here, so it must have been quite an adjustment back then to get people to think about this shift, because it's amazing to me. Some of the most effective members of the business community become a mom and are taken out of the fold, and we leave them there.
Yep.
And we don't allow access to entry. So you've gone and done this report to do a deep dive to find out what women in South Africa actually need to be successful in the workspace. So let's talk through some of those findings. What really jumped off the page for you?
So what happened was post-COVID, we started to see a shift. So we have almost 200,000 women in our database at the moment, and we started to notice a larger number of women coming into the workplace looking for work, and also a greater number of them looking for full-time employment. And so we started to ask ourselves, so what's happening economically amongst women in South Africa? And there wasn't the data. So we decided, well, we couldn't just anecdotally come to market and say, this is what's happening. We needed to do the research. Uh-huh. So together with a number of other influencers in South Africa and people in South Africa, we put out the research, and about 2,500 women responded, and they in this report then began to tell us what they wanted, and that's what we've released to the market.
And I'm thinking there are multiple ways that you can push this perspective, this as a product in itself. What were some of the myths, or maybe those misconceptions that this data, these metrics have dispelled? What have been some of your biggest, like, wow, okay, those kind of moments?
So I think there are a number of perceptions around how women want to work, and particularly working mothers. Yeah. And there seems to be, this belief that working mothers are not serious about their careers, that they want to work part-time, and they want to work remotely. And what we found from the research was that 98% of the women said we want to work, 78% of them said they wanted to grow, and the majority of them want to work full-time, and actually the majority of them also want to work in a hybrid manner. And that was an interesting aha for us, because we also thought that the majority of women would want to work remotely, fully remotely. But because of COVID, there's this greater need for connection and social interaction. And so there's this now growing need for more hybrid work. You still have about 30% of women wanting to work fully remotely, especially when their kids are a bit younger. But
or those that have better behaved kids. Maybe they just don't want to escape it. I love the fact that we are turning this lens onto a member or a group of members of the workforce that are untapped as a resource. This isn't about creating room for a nice to have. This is essential for the growth of this country. We need to utilize the best assets that we have. And that's exactly the focus here. So we're going to continue this discussion with Philippa in just a moment. We are speaking about women in the workplace and how that landscape is transforming to prime itself for these assets. And we'd love for you to weigh into the conversation. But first, let's cook a sub.
Oh, thanks, G-Man. Well, listen, we are so excited that today is International Women's Day, and we're going to be celebrating by doing a series of subs this Friday in the kitchen. And today, joining us, we have content creator and recipe developer Dre. Now, this next recipe, it promises to be a hit with everyone who tries it. Now, you simply can't go wrong with a cheesy steak sub cooked to perfection. It is great for game day, a braai, or even just a lazy weekend meal. Dre, I love a good steak sub. How about you?
Love them, absolutely love them.
How do you eat your steak first and foremost? When you go to a restaurant and you order a steak, are you medium rare?
Definitely medium, medium girl.
Are you a medium girl?
I don't like going too overboard and too under, so definitely in the middle.
Definitely in the middle. I personally am more on the rare side, medium rare. Mm. So we've got some beautiful steak pieces here, and I believe you're going to start taking us through how to prepare our steak for our sub.
Yes, so we're going to start by searing our steak. We just add that to the oil. I think it is hot. Yeah, it was hot. And then we just add our spices.
And I know you've got some onion powder as well as a little bit of paprika going on.
Some paprika as well as Worcestershire sauce.
Yes.
I think that always gets everyone.
I think if you say Worcestershire sauce, everyone knows
what you're talking about. You can also say W sauce. And then we're just going to stir this and cook it until it's just about seared, making sure that the seasoning gets on all the strips.
And the thing with strips is, especially if you love your steak medium, myself, we can go for medium rare. They cook really quickly because they are so thin, and we've got a nice hot pan, so you don't have to overcook your steak strips. Because I've had some steak strips where it's so dry because they just overcook it.
And you're literally pulling away from the sandwich, so you just want to make sure that it's like this. And then we're just going to leave that to cook for a little bit. And the rolls are already toasted. You want to make sure that your rolls are toasted so it doesn't get soggy.
Okay.
Yeah.
We've got some beautiful ingredients here. Now, as a content creator and a recipe developer, where did your love for food originate from?
I love eating and I love experimenting with food. And I just literally started during lockdown, and I really was like bored at home, and I started posting on my personal page and people are like, we want the recipe. So that's pretty much how I started making content. And yeah, just love experimenting with food.
Oh, fantastic. Yeah. Is there specific food that you would say is your go-to?
Sandwiches, definitely, burgers, and a good pasta, and pizza.
Oh, yeah. See, there's quite a few.
So quite a few.
Why even box it in?
No, yeah, TBH.
Okay.
Okay, so this is cooking.
Yeah, looking beautiful.
It's looking good. The color is amazing.
Yeah. We do want a little color.
Yeah, we do want a bit of color on there. Maybe we can turn up the heat.
We can turn up the heat for you a little bit. I'll do that over there. We'll turn it up a bit.
Yes.
Fantastic. So once we add the rest of our ingredients, it's all about assembling. Mm-hmm. Are you someone that loves leftovers? Do you ever experiment with turning leftovers into a new meal? Because I'm just thinking, you go to a steak restaurant, instead of ordering your usual 200 grams, you now go for the 300 grams or the 400 grams, and whatever is left over, you can turn into sub for lunch the next day.
Literally, especially with like chicken and like big meals like that, you want to always make sure that you don't waste. So I like thinking of like new recipes to try out, to make them, and sandwiches are a good idea, or nachos, or whatever you think of, really. Yeah, as long as we're not wasting food.
As long as we're not wasting. The nice thing is we are using steak right now, so you can really personalize this recipe. If chicken is more your feel, go for chicken. Perhaps you want to play with pork, you can also do that. We do have this recipe with all of the ingredients available on our website, so you can just head on over to expressoshow.com. I feel like, Dre, those steak pieces are absolutely perfect. Yes.
So now we want to add our onions whilst the steak is not yet quite where we want it to be, so it doesn't overcook. So we just add our onions as well as the peppers.
And I love the colours. I love that we're going for the red onion and the green peppers. It really just brings some freshness to this recipe.
True. I love a good red onion. very fragrant. So I just want to cook the vegetables to make sure that they still have a little bit of a bite to them, but they're like fragrant and like cooked.
Yes, yes, definitely. So while you're finishing up the recipe, we do have a finished product here. We've added some cheese because we want to go for the cheesy steak roll. So I'm just going to start assembling our toasted little bun here. And we've got this beautiful ingredients. I feel like we are missing some of the fresh veggies from there. Yeah. But you just have this beautiful sub that you can close. And you get to enjoy it. I mean, you can serve it up with some dips. You can either do with some tomato sauce. We've got sweet chili sauce. So we really have quite a few varieties. I personally will just add a little bit more cheese to get that cheesiness to it.
Yeah.
And then we've got the finished product there. You're just going to finish it off with a little bit of
barbecue sauce.
Oh.
Just to make sure we get like a nice smoky flavor. I'm going to put all of it.
Oh, fancy.
And just mix that up. And it's actually starting to smell good. Once you start to smell the peppers, that's when you know you're close to where you want to be.
Oh, that to me looks like it's absolutely perfect. If you want to get your hands on this recipe, it is available on our website, expressoshow.com. And perhaps the two of us can have the honor of slicing into this beautiful one that we have that's ready. The only thing with these subs, I don't know if there's a ladylike way to eat it.
There really isn't. You just have to go in for it.
You just have to go in for it. So I'm going to give us a beautiful big cut. Mm-hmm. And we'll try in the background of Graham telling us what's happening on the show to be ladylike. So, G-Man, what's coming up on the show?
Well, yes, we're going to try and discover a ladylike way to eat a sub, which I think is impossible. You just got to do it. Just dive right in. And then, of course, is there a ladylike way to do business? Yes, there is. In South Africa, there is one of our, I think, most prime focuses within that space right now to develop that asset. We are sitting on a gold mine. So we're going to continue to look at that conversation with Philippa in just a moment. Women in the workplace and how the landscape is changing. And then, of course, there is 2,000 rand to be given away, and it could be going to you. We will see you in just a moment. Go and refresh yourself. We'll see you now.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Oh, welcome back. This is a good one. If I'm enjoying this conversation as much as I am, you have some gems to glean from it. We are continuing a very important conversation with Philippa Geard, the very proud founder and CEO of the incredible Recruit My Mom, the company that has brought out the largest and I think most pertinent report done to date in South Africa around working women. What does her research reveal about the level of satisfaction of women in the workplace, and also how we are not tapping into a resource that is staring us right in the face? And I'm going to grossly overgeneralize here, but you've been talking about an aha moment. When I talk about this asset within the workplace, how much of an asset is that? Let's talk about the qualifications, the education, this pool of talent and resource that we're not tapping into.
Yeah. So women in South Africa are underrepresented by about 11% in the workforce. And what we're seeing is that there are more women entering tertiary educations, tertiary institutions, and graduating from tertiary institutions and entering the workforce. So if you've got more females and males being more educated and entering the workforce, yet you look up towards the JSE and you look at the senior executives, you've got 15% of women. So the question is, what's happening in the middle and why? And people will ordinarily say, well, that's the mother factor, right?
It's you going, having kids, and then you're
leaving.
You're gone, yeah.
But what we're finding in the research is that you've got a large percentage of women in that junior middle management level, and then often it is the child-rearing years. But if companies could just bridge that and move them into the next level of management, they would then be able to get them into senior management. And if this is the future of our workforce, in terms of more females being educated, more females entering, then isn't it... doesn't it make sense in a market where we've got so many issues?
But that's the whole point of the system, is it not? To educate along a steady long-term arc and then rely on that education, that resource, when it enters into the workforce. So in your mind, what is that bottleneck? What is stopping or creating the skew? I know there are structures in place, the old boys club, a mentoring system within business that is so easy for a man to go out and look for his mentor or someone to help carve his path. These are very traditional models that I do understand because I'm a man. From a female perspective, what is causing this skew? Is it just the way it's always been, or are there bigger picture kind of elements at play?
Yeah, so what you're seeing is that companies are not fully being able to bridge the career pauses that women take. So a woman may take a career pause, and they can be of varying lengths. And so they're not engaging women enough around returning over past those career pauses. That's number one. Secondly, women are seeing that there aren't enough opportunities for growth. So if companies and employers could just recognize that if they could move them from the junior management into a middle towards senior, they would then be able to get them up into executives.
And there they would have the flexibility and the confidence and the power with or power base to be able to be more flexible in the way that works for them.
And they would be able to see mentors. So one of the barriers that women are perceiving is there's no mentors for them to see looking up.
Well, that's just not enough, because only one out of the 10 execs is a woman to see yourself in that position. So if the other nine are men, I'm going to go to another company that has maybe two or three women in that position to see that arc. How do we address this? So are we speaking to the CEOs right now, or are we speaking to women within that gap kind of phase of their life?
Well, I would like to say we need to speak to both. First of all, to CEOs, is recognize that the future of work is female. There are more of them entering, there are more of them that are educated. So what's the strategy? What's the plan to get them to executive level? Because at the end of the day, that's what we ideally need. And then secondly, for women to really have those conversations. You know, they are an asset. We've got a skills shortage in South Africa. They've got incredible skills. A lot of them more educated now. So start to engage with management on what is required, particularly around flexible working, in order to alleviate all the concerns that might come with flexible working.
We have an opportunity now, and I think the world is being gateway through this. And when we talk about the future of work being woman, we're not talking about an emotional conversation and the soft skills that are involved with managerial styles or anything like that. We are talking about a hard resource on paper, educated members of the workforce that are being left out in the cold. And we are screaming to connect the dots with employment, with management style, with being future focused, with helping young people enter into the market. The skills are there, paid for through varsity, through all of these degrees, we're not tapping into it. And it's partly the CEOs who, yes, have to turn a lens inwards to find out about the woman within their own workforce. But I think most importantly, we need to take days like today to put our hands up. And I say our very loosely because it is your time, woman, to take ownership of your space. So have these conversations and reach out to incredible mentors that are there ready to guide you through the process. You're amazing. What you represent is absolutely amazing. Please weigh in on the conversation.
Oh, thank you, Graham. Well, listen, when it comes to our kids, why settle for less than giving your children the very best at-home medication for pain and fever relief? Well, Panado is giving you the chance to not only relieve that pain and fever, but you also stand a chance to win 2,000 Rand cash. All you had to do was name one of the four additive frees which the new grape is free from and tell us why Panado grape is the clear choice for you as a parent using that hashtag power to fight pain and hashtag Panado essay on our social media competition post. Now we have our third lucky winner on the line. Can I get a drum roll, please? Congratulations to Temba Maseko. Good morning, Temba.
Good morning, how are you?
I am good, thank you. Listen, I love what you said. So this is your comment. Temba said, the fact that it is alcohol-free means it cannot make kids drowsy like other medications. Hashtag Panado essay, hashtag power to fight pain. Well, Temba, we are so excited. Let's celebrate with this grape win with Temba. How are you going to spend that 2,000 Rand that is especially yours?
I think I will buy my son a bicycle because he's been trying for it, and I'll buy some groceries for the family.
Oh, that would be so special. Well, Temba, I have to ask you this because Panado, they have a wide range that is equally as amazing, but do you perhaps have a favorite variant?
Yes, it's a Panado paracetamol that helps with mild pain caused by headaches and toothaches.
Oh, that is super impressive. Well, Temba, congratulations. That 2,000 Rand is yours thanks to Panado. Enjoy it.
Thank you.
Oh, there we go. Well, be your child's superhero like Temba is to his every day as they fight off pain and fever. Now, Panado Grape is giving you the chance to be one of 10 lucky winners getting their hands on 2,000 Rand cash. And if you want to know how to enter, here's how.
Panado Grape gives you the power to fight their pain in a new flavor that tastes great. I mean, grape. To celebrate the new grape taste, this 4th to the 15th of March, Panado offers you 10 chances to win 2,000 Rand cash. Just answer the questions on the Panado post on Expresso's social media pages using hashtag PanadoSA and hashtag power to fight pain. T's and C's apply. Panado Grape, it's a clear choice in fast pain and fever relief.
It's a show, we're feeling good, and it's round about the time you have breakfast, so it must be your feel-good breakfast show. You're live on S3, and we are about to get into some very exciting things, my friend. First and foremost, Peter Schaefer's iconic play Amadeus is opening tonight, and we've got all of the details that you need to know. And then, we're going to be getting into celebrating women in the gaming industry, and it, of course, is so right because of International Women's Day. Make sure you do not go anywhere, because all of that and a whole lot more is coming up right here on Expresso. We're going to take a short break, but we'll be back on the other side of this.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back, beautiful Expresso family. You're still on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. And this morning, we have got two people who honestly and truly are exactly what the youth needs to be. Talented. Thank you very much. I'm talking about the fact that today it is exciting. It is Peter Schaefer's iconic play Amadeus that is opening at Peter Taurine's Monte Cassino Theatre tonight. And it is going to be something for your eyes to definitely see. And I'm talking about the fact that when we look at what Peter Schaefer did with Amadeus, it is genuinely one for the books, which is why I'm so excited that yet again, many generations get to be inspired by it. A tale that is all about vengeance, jealousy, and passion. And I'm so excited as well because we've got the two leads that are going to be actually leading everybody into a beautiful, beautiful tale. So everyone, please welcome two humans from Cape Town. It is, of course, Aidan Scott, who plays Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, as well as the beautiful Lisa Tredu, who plays his wife, Constanza. Welcome to the show. Hi, guys.
Hey.
How are you feeling?
Tired, but good.
Yeah.
We've just done like 3 weeks of rehearsals and we clocked out 12 o'clock last night, but we're good in a week.
Oh my God. And I was going to say, you know, and it's also a good thing that like for the next month, you're going to be just, you know, going over and over again.
Yeah, it's like the same play every night.
Literally.
You know, 7:30 and we do it for 2 hours and then we're done.
And then you're done. Well, it's a good thing that you love it. But Lisa, I want to ask you, for anyone who doesn't know at home, what is Amadeus all about?
So, a lot of people think it's about Mozart, but it's not actually. It's the story of Salieri, who kind of revisits his younger life and his younger self as he grapples with jealousy and guilt. And yeah, I think we all have someone that we can look at and think, man, I really wish I was as good as them.
Yeah.
And that's Salieri's whole problem with Mozart.
Yeah, and you're genuinely right. That's something that almost everyone feels, but you must never feed into it. But this is why it's also interesting to see how it plays out in Amadeus,
it's educational.
Right? 100%. But I want to ask you, sir, because you're someone who has toured the world playing all of these different characters. What was different about this character and just in terms of you being challenged by it?
It's like you think Mozart and you just think kind of weird white hair and like conducting and composing and making, you know, these like classical weird sounds. And he feels so kind of grand, but at the end of the day he was just a kind of guy that was a child in his heart. And so the script was amazing because he, like, one of his first lines is he loves poo jokes and he loves like fart sounds and stuff. And I'm just like, this is not the Mozart that I learnt about.
No.
But this is the Mozart that I love.
Yeah.
And it was based off a lot of the letters that he wrote to his parents. And he just like dropped fart jokes and poo jokes. And I'm like, this is amazing.
I love that.
But also a genius.
Yeah, 100%. We never forget that part. Someone who seems like a genius as well, though, is you, Lisa. Because you
personally,
are.
Or my character?
No, you. Oh. Because you're an illustrator, you're an actress, you're also a children's book author, you're all of these different things. How do you do all of it? And you know, how do you also make sure that you zero in on each and every one of them?
Well, I think luckily and unluckily, being an actress in this country means that there's a lot of unemployment time.
Sure.
So I have lots of time to do other things.
I think it's just being a freelancer in this. I have 12
true,
jobs after
true.
This.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes. But it's also because you love it, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, most definitely.
I also think that when it comes to people who are in the entertainment industry and in even the acting industry, seeing your passion is always so easy. Do you know what I mean?
Big time.
Big time. But let's talk about this in terms of the cast and everyone coming together. What was it like in terms of you guys, you know, making sure that you genuinely were staying true to the actual play itself?
So interestingly enough, the play is usually done with about 30 cast members.
Mm-hmm.
That's an expensive show, and it looks very pretty, and it's a very expensive show. We're doing it with 8 people, which is, so we have kind of people doubling up in different roles, and all actors are on stage at all times, which is just, I don't know, it's a really special part about this production.
Costume changes, scene changes.
In front of the audience.
Setting changes, everything happens in front of your eyes, and it's kind of like all constantly moving.
Oh, wow, guys, I love that. And for both of you, what do you love most about what you guys have done with this and what the audience can expect?
I don't know, the generational thing where it's like we have 2 actors that are 20 years old, we have 2 actors that are 30, we have a 40-year-old and we have a 60-year-old, and it's just this generational blend of like different ideas, different ways of working, and different kind of skin colors and different genders, and it's just a beautiful mixed match of beautiful people telling a classic old story, but in a way that kind of feels real today.
Come on.
That's exciting, you know?
That is exciting. I love that. Guys, I can already tell from your energy that it's going to be amazing. It's going to be an experience. Also, tickets. Do you know where people can get them?
Web tickets.
Web tickets. Beautiful.
Just Google it.
That is my favorite answer. I'm so done. These two are a lot, but this is the thing. This is what you always want when you're going off to go and experience something, because you can tell that they give their all, and it is going to be happening. Like I said, from tonight, the 8th of March, all the way until the 7th of April, it is Peter Schaefer's Amadeus, and it is opening at Monte Casino tonight. For now, though, we, of course, have so much still coming up right here on your Feel Good Breakfast show, and the beautiful Zoe is standing by in Cape Town. Hi, Zoe.
Thank you, Zanele. Well, listen, with International Women's Day being today, it's also important to highlight the places where women are advocating for their space. Now, the gaming scene is one of those where women are often overlooked or even treated with hostility for taking up space. Now, today, we are speaking to some gamers who are hosting a tournament just for women and femme gamers in their efforts to highlight that not only are there many women in gaming, but that there's a very viable space for those who make the gamers, as well as the games and the hardware and everything to be taken notice of. Now, for that, we welcome Jess Hines to studio, as well as Adam Thomas James, who is ACGL Esports Education Specialist. So it's great to have both of you here. But Jess, I'm going to start off with you.
Yes.
It's a very exciting tournament starting today.
Yes.
Tell me more about this tournament.
So this is our third annual one, which is very exciting. And every year we've just seen it basically double in size in terms of competitors and in terms of prizes. So this year, we're very, very excited. And yes, it will be running later today, starting at 11 o'clock. Rishka, my co-host, who couldn't be here this morning. I know she's watching. You can watch from her channel first, and then I will be streaming the same tournament in the evening. We didn't feel like battling load shedding, so we just did the two slots. And this year we're doing Valorant, so it's everyone for themselves. And it just makes it easy peasy, and ACGL is thankfully handling all of the tournament aspects, so we just have to be there and host.
So did people have to sign up? Is this how does the tournament work? What can people expect?
Yeah, so we did do personalized invites to previous competitors, as we do every year, and then we also opened up signups. We gave a week for everyone who felt like joining, and basically as long as you were a South African resident and you had some sort of a rank in Valorant, we opened it up to all ranks, and you identify as femme, you could take part. So we have over 70. I don't actually know what the actual number is anymore, because there's been so many people, but there's definitely over 70 competitors this year, which is quite a lot.
That is exciting. And it's amazing that ACGL is part of it. Adam, why is it so important for you guys to support this tournament?
So this tournament is very close to our hearts. It's always been part of our core, what we want to do for the community. Besides this, we also run events with high schools, primary schools, universities, all empowering women from the bottom up. So just being able to showcase this is a complete honor for us. In terms of all of these events, Jess and Rishka really have been trailblazing the way for lots of women into coming into gaming, which can be a hostile environment, like you've mentioned. And even besides the events that showcase it so well, consistently letting girls and women play in a safe space in all of the leagues is very important to us, because that's how we believe that the environment will grow.
Yeah, definitely. Now, Jess, this is the third annual Femmes and Thems that you are hosting. How has it grown?
It's grown significantly. I mean, just quickly, last year by the numbers, we had 2.2 million in reach. And our viewership on Twitch, just with the few streamers we had then, was over 180,000 people. So this year it will hopefully be more, because we have more people. And, you know, our biggest audience was women aged 18 to 24. So it does really show that there is a huge interest in women, specifically young women in this gaming industry, that want to take part in these events. So this year, with more people being involved, we're hoping obviously to do better than those numbers.
Of course.
And keep it growing each year. And I know we have a big goal to hopefully next year or the year after expand it to the continent, which is a big goal, but it's good to kind of, you know, reach for the stars. And
definitely.
Because it's African gaming. It's not just South African gaming. See? Yeah.
That's why we have it. I love it. And I love that you even have it on your sleeve over there, Adam. Now, for anyone that wants to stay up to date, be part of the stream, to see all of the action, where can they see it?
If you go onto Twitter or Instagram or basically any social media and you just search for the hashtag ACG and then ELLE, you will find basically everyone posting about it and everyone posting links throughout the day. And then if you check Rishka and myself on social media, then you will find direct links to all the Twitch channels there. And then on the ACGL Twitch channel, we have our wonderful casters who are also women, because there's many disciplines where women are in. Androva and Eos Praxi, they're casting the tournament today, and their POV will be on that channel.
That's amazing. Yes. Well, to the both of you, thank you for joining us. Jess, good luck with the tournament today. And if you want to follow them, you can see at hashtag ACGL, that's ELLE. Those details should appear on your screen right now, and you can watch that tournament later today.
Trailblazers, indeed. We love you, Jess. Adam, you're cool as well. You can stick around. We want you guys at home to stick around. Why? Because we introduced you to the incredible cast of Amadeus. We're going to get a little taste of that production after this. Then, of course, one of the best in the biz, Renee DeVitt, is going to give us some foundation tips and tricks. She is amazing. You want to stick around for that plug-in. We'll see you now.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Welcome back, welcome back. You're on Expresso right here on S3. And oh my goodness, I can't believe it. We're only 1 hour in and so much has already happened. But we, of course, told you about the play Amadeus that is opening at Peter Taurine's Theatre at Monte Cassino. And it is so exciting because this morning we actually got to speak to two of the leads. But this is the thing. We are actually getting a little bit of a taste of what is going to be coming through from the king who is playing Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. I'm talking about Aidan Scott. Sir, I need to ask you, because we need a little bit of context here. What is this monologue about that you're about to put us into?
Mozart's basically writing his own kind of thing that goes completely against what everyone's been writing. Mm-hmm. And everyone's like, that's not cool, stop doing that. And he's like, no, I'm gonna do it, and this is why I'm gonna do it.
Come on! It sounds like spicy Mozart to me.
Spicy.
I love that. Okay, perfect. Here we go. Everybody, it is Aidan Scott.
Us. Four gaping mouths, a perfect quartet. Oh, I could write it just this second in time, this now, as you are. Herr Chamberlain thinking impertinent Mozart, I must speak to the Emperor at once. Herr Prefect thinking ignorant Mozart, debasing opera with his vulgarity. Herr Court Composer thinking German Mozart, what can he finally know about the music? And Herr Mozart himself in the middle thinking, I'm a good fellow. Why must you all disapprove of me? And that is why opera is so important. Because it is realer than any play. Well, a dramatic poet would have to take all those ideas and put them down one after another just to represent this second in time. The composer can put them all down at once and still make us hear each one of them. Oh, I tell you, I could write a finale lasting half an hour. A quartet becoming a quintet, becoming a sextet, on and on, wider and wider, all sounds rising and multiplying together, and the together becoming a sound entirely new. I bet you that's how God hears the world. Millions of sounds ascending and mixing in his ear, becoming an unending music unimaginable to us. And that is our job. That is our job. We, composers, combining the inner minds of him and her and the thoughts of chambermaids and court composers, and turn the audience into God. That's me.
My goodness! Did you see that talent? This is a gifted man indeed. And yes, he is one of the leads of Amadeus opening from today, the 8th of March, up until the 7th of April at Peter Torin's Monte Cassino Theatre. You are just the one who needs to go and get tickets, eh? On web tickets, do the right thing. For now, though, Zoe is standing by with your news.
Thank you, Zanele. It is 7 o'clock. Let's look at your national headlines. President Cyril Ramaphosa has labelled the situation in the war-torn Gaza Strip as, and I quote, beyond human contemplation or understanding. Now, his remarks came hours after South Africa petitioned the International Court of Justice to impose fresh emergency measures on Israel over what is described as widespread starvation resulting from its Gaza offensive. Citing the UN Office for the Coordination of Humanitarian Affairs, South Africa said in its application this, and I quote, is the last opportunity that this court shall have to save the Palestinian people in Gaza already dying of starvation and now one step away from famine. And the court appearance of four suspects implicated in the disappearance of six-year-old Jocelyn Smith, who went missing more than 2 weeks ago in Saldanha, has been postponed until Wednesday in the Vredenburg Magistrates Court. The accused, including her mother and her boyfriend, will remain in custody until then, when a formal bail application is set to be heard. The suspects, Jacqueline Apollis, Stavino van Rijn, Raquel Chantal Smith and Pumza Sikakwa, face charges of trafficking persons for purposes of exploitation and kidnapping. It's understood that more arrests are likely to follow. And moving to news abroad, President Joe Biden is to announce that the US military will construct a port in Gaza to bring more humanitarian aid into the territory by sea, senior US officials say. The temporary port will increase the amount of humanitarian assistance to Palestinians by hundreds of additional truckloads per day, but it will not include US troops on the ground in Gaza. The United Nations has warned that a quarter of the population of Gaza is on the brink of famine. And three West African countries run by military juntas say they will form a joint force to fight jihadist threats. Niger, Mali and Burkina Faso announced the formation of the force following talks in Niamey, capital of Niger. Niger's army chief announced it would be operational as soon as possible. Groups linked to both Islamic State and Al-Qaeda have killed thousands of people in the past year in the three countries. The military regimes have strengthened ties with Russia of late. And a recent study suggests that, like fine wine, birds improve with age in their migratory journey. Scientists observing storks found that older birds navigate more efficiently, developing shortcuts learned from previous experiences, while younger birds take longer routes. conducted by researchers from Wyoming University in the US and the Max Planck Institute of Animal Behavior in Germany, the study emphasizes the importance of experimental learning in successful migration. It involved tracking some 250 storks across Germany and Austria between 2013 and 2020. The findings indicate that as birds age, they become more adept at navigation, opting for quicker, more direct routes. So in the grand symphony of migration, age truly brings delightful savvy. Well, someone that is extremely savvy in this studio is Graham Richards, and he's standing by with your sport.
Oh, press the beep button right now. No, I love it. You can't teach an old dog, but an old bird, yep, you got you covered. It's all about that conservation of energy. Now let's speak about some energy exerted last night, and they did it in style. We start with football, and Liverpool delivered a commanding performance, thrashing Sparta Prague 5-1 in the first leg of the Europa League last 16 tie. So an early penalty by Alexi McAllister set the tone, followed by a Darwin Nunez double, and then a goal from Luis Diaz, despite Sparta's consolation goal and a VAR ruling out of Mohamed Salah's effort. Dominic Szoboszlai, he added a fifth in injury time to seal the deal. So Liverpool now holding a commanding advantage heading into that second leg. It's going to be a tough one to overturn. Now we turn to rugby, and Ireland, of course, aiming for a grand slam this year. Welcome back Hugo Keenan for tomorrow's Six Nations showdown with England at the famed Twickenham. And the world-class fullback fit again after a knee issue. He comes in to replace Kieran Fawley in that starting 15. However, Ireland will be missing lock James Ryan for the remainder of the tournament, and he's been an outstanding player for them this year, and that's due to a freak bicep injury suffered in training. So Ryan's absence now extends to next week's finale as well, up against Scotland. Well, as I said, they'll be hoping to complete that Grand Slam. Now we turn to cricket and more dominance. In fact, on a dominant opening day for India in the fifth test, Kuldeep Yadav's 5-wicket haul helping bundle England out for 218 in their first innings. Yadav's figures are 5-72, supported by Ravi Chandran. Ashwin's 4 wickets in his 100th test, great milestone, saw India dismissing the visitors in just 57.4 overs. Then stepped in skipper Rohit Sharma with 52 and Shubman Gill on 26. They were unbeaten at stumps yesterday, with India reaching 135-1 at the very picturesque Dharamsala Stadium, now trailing England by 83 runs. That match should be up and running again momentarily. Then we turn to motorsports, and Fernando Alonso still making headlines, of course, now driving for Aston Martin. He topped yesterday's floodlit second practice for the Saudi Arabian Grand Prix. That was following Max Verstappen's earlier pace-setting performance. The Mercedes' George Russell securing second spot on the grid, trailing Alonso by 0.230 seconds, and then Verstappen here to settle the third, 0.331 seconds behind Alonso. And the practice sessions took place at Jeddah's incredible Corniche circuit, with the race being held a day earlier, of course, to coincide with the start of Ramadan on Sunday night, which is, I think, is a great move amid a record 24 race season. Jam them in. We are here for that as the fans. But that's where we leave our sport for now. Let's take a look at the roads.
Thank you, Graham. Well, we start off with your traffic in Phoenix, Durban. There's protesting taking place in Phoenix and Palmview area, and it's causing heavy congestion. Avoid the affected areas and please plan an alternative route. In Khayelitsha in Cape Town, there's been an accident on the N2 inbound. It's after the ramp from Miway, and there are delays to be expected. Maintain a safe following distance as roads are wet and slippery this morning. That's your traffic. Let's take another look at your weather. And we have some encouraging news this morning concerning water in the Johannesburg Water Region. Well, in fact, they say that there are improvements in the supply to Soweto, parts of Roodepoort, and the Commando system, which includes Brixton, Crosby, and Hurst Hill. Many areas in Johannesburg have been without water for days after two power outages at the Rand Waters Akenhof pumping station. Johannesburg Water says that although the pumping station has resumed operations at full capacity since late on Tuesday evening, it may still take up to a week for systems to be fully restored. 27 tankers have been deployed to supply water to the areas still experiencing shortages. It is 7 a.m. Let's take another look at a sunrise view, and Alice from Pietermaritzburg is gracing us with hers. You can see the beautiful cloud cover in the foreground, but if you would love to share your morning view, you're welcome to do so on our WhatsApp line. That number is 063-408-8863. Let's take a look at your temperatures for your Friday. Oh, well, those are your temperatures for your Friday across the country. Well, we are taking the quickest of breaks on your Feel Good Breakfast show. When we get back, we have Renee DeWitt with us in studio, and it's all about finding the perfect foundation and getting all those tips and tricks from the pro herself. And then we have The Soil in studio. They are ready to grace us with a fantastic performance. They're bringing their energy, and we can't wait to share that with you. So stay tuned. Stand the chance to win a year's tuition bursary with Stadio Higher Education. If you've matriculated but haven't secured a place to study or want to make this the year of your career growth,
well, then WhatsApp the word Stadio to 068-565-4114 and tell us what you'll do once you achieve the degree of your dreams and study with Stadio.
A new vision in higher education. Competition runs 4 to 15 March. T's and C's apply.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Let's continue to celebrate International Women's Day, and today casting a spotlight on women in the workplace specifically. So we put it to you guys this morning to tell us, inspire us with those women in your world, in your workplace, who inspire you. We've had some great comments come through, and we wanted to focus on this one from Pabalo. In fact, a voice note. Let's hear from them right now.
Good morning, Espresso. My woman that actually inspired me, it's my mother and myself. My mother, she is a very consistent, down-to-earth, calm woman that never backs down. From that spirit, I have taken and I have injected in myself that to be a bigger and better person, this is how I should be and this is how I should act accordingly. So thank you to my mom. You are my inspiration.
You are my inspiration. Sometimes you have to say the words out loud. So go and do it. Drop us a voice note. Drop by any of our social media platforms. 063-408-8863 is the number to use if you want your voice heard this morning. Luckily, when I'm looking for inspirational women who inspire me within the workspace, I don't have to throw a rock very far to find one. In fact, I get to work with one almost every day. So let's hand over to her.
Oh, thank you, G-Man. Well, listen, when it comes to getting that flawless skin to look like a shiny rock, it is all about the perfect foundation, and that is the finish, and it's no secret. So don't worry, because we are here to help you if you're struggling with mismatched neck and crease concealer, and perhaps you can't get that flawless look that you want. That's why we've asked makeup professional Renee DeWitt to come and help us out. Renee, it's always so great to have you here.
Thank
you.
Because
you have the most beautiful skin. Our model has the most gorgeous skin, but it all comes down to skin preparation. Now, when it comes to hydrating the skin, I know that plays a key role in the foundation. What can we do to make sure our skin stays as hydrated as possible?
Okay, so it's very important to know your skin type. So if your skin is slightly dehydrated, if it's dry, you know, there's certain tips and tools that you can break, you know, kind of fix your skin. So what I like to do is when I apply my, before I apply my foundation, I take a little bit of hyaluronic serum, but I don't just apply it to the skin, I apply it to damp skin. And what I found is really magic is if I take a little bit of the glowing mist and I just mist it with a damp skin, it just locks in the moisture. And you can add this to your foundation to get the glow.
So don't be afraid of moisture. You don't have to start off on a dry, plain canvas. Start with that hydrating canvas.
Absolutely.
I love that.
I think what happens is when you put a foundation on a skin that's not hydrated, it sees it as moisture and absorbs it, and that's why your foundation tends to slide off.
Okay.
That's why the hydration part is just so essential.
I think it's important to understand you need that hydration in order for your foundation to stay and look beautiful. A lot of people battle pigmentation, blemishes. Mm. I've got quite a few breakouts and we want to cover them up properly.
You're perfect.
They've been covered up. But what's the best way to spot treat those dark marks?
Yeah, so I had an incident with a mosquito last night and I have a gazillion mosquito bites on my face. So I'm the perfect person to explain to you what to do. So after you do your hydration, you do your foundation, the best thing to do is just to take a little bit of makeup fixing spray. This is like my holy grail. Spray it onto the beauty blender. When you do your concealer and you spot it on, push it into the skin. Push it in. And that way it's locked in. You still have the hydration, but you've covered your mosquito bites or your blemishes or your pigmentation.
I love that. I love that. I knew Renee is the perfect person to ask all my burning questions with. Now, we all want that flawless foundation look. How do we make sure we've got the right shade? Because I'm someone where I'm very big on sunblock, so now the problem is my body is a different shade to my face, but I need the foundation to match everywhere. How can we make sure we've got an even look?
So this is the tricky part, because Madam has just been on holiday, so she's super tan, but her face obviously is a lot lighter. So what I do when I try out my foundation or I consult with clients, I always say, try, don't buy. So when you go in store, you find three shades that are the closest to your skin tone.
Okay.
And you swatch them, not on your hands, always on your cheek, your chin, your forehead, and a little bit in your neck. There's never going to be one shade that's absolutely perfect.
Okay.
But you can slightly dilute the shade by adding a bit of serum or a bit of moisturizer. And then once you've placed your foundation in certain areas, go have a coffee, walk around, give it 20, 30 minutes to see if it oxidizes, if it changes. The color that stays truest to you, that is your color.
That is your color. You just need to remember which sample you put where. I always love that, because when you go to a store, the light is always different. And you go into a different store, the light's different there. So I love that.
Try, don't buy.
Try, don't buy.
So we've matched her to Golden Caramel. So application techniques, what I find, different skin tones, different skin types, and how to have this beautiful, long, glowing skin. Mm. There's a million ways of doing it. If you want a really flawless, more full cover, I tend to moisten my sponge with the makeup fixing spray. I put a little bit on the back of my hand, and then I pat it into the skin.
You pat it?
I pat it into the skin. But also, because I've used the makeup setting spray, that color is not going to shift.
Okay.
And it's going to be hydrated. If you feel that's a bit too much coverage, you can take your foundation and buff it out.
Ah, right? Okay.
Or if you really want extra, you can stipple it into your skin, okay, which is really a lovely way of covering that nasty pigmentation spots.
Okay, I love that. So you use the fixing spray to wet your beauty blender. Is it wrong to use water, like to wash your beauty blender under the basin?
No.
Okay.
I mean, that's ideal. You have to moisten it first.
Okay.
And once it's moistened, that's when you put your makeup setting spray. If your skin's like super dry and it's winter, I tend to use a little bit of this magic, which is the glow toner, on a cotton pad beforehand, and then I will add a little bit of the hydration onto my sponge, and I would do fixing. So it's a little bit of layering and a little bit of playing around with different kinds of moisture.
Okay, I absolutely love that. Now, how will we finish off her look?
Right, so if you're over a certain age, like myself, I tend to avoid powders, but obviously you want your makeup to stay put. So what I do is if I use my concealer, for example, underneath the eyes, I'll pat it in and I'll keep looking up, take my finger, add a little, I would...
All over, because you've got flawless skin.
You want just, the glow.
You want the glow, and the powder takes that away.
Exactly.
It's such a tough one, because you want the glow, but you want the makeup to stay, and it's only the powder that can do that, but I love all the tips you've given us.
Thank you.
Renee, thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
And did you know, in fact, 70% of women wear the wrong foundation. So head on over to your nearest Woolworths store to get your foundation matched and shop all of your foundation coverage needs at Woolworths Beauty. It's available in-store, online, as well as on the Woolies app.
Oh, thank you so much, ladies. Some absolute gems there. And if you want more of that, stick around. The inspiration continues to flow. We've got one of the most incredibly talented outfits in the country in our studios this morning. And Sika, Lupindo and Theo are here, otherwise known as The Soil. We cannot wait to catch up with some really good old friends of the show. And then just to treat them this morning, we are whipping up something healthy, scrumptious and quite out the box. It's an avo bacon jam and halloumi roll, and they are spectacular and just about bite-sized, which is perfect for TV land. We'll see you now.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Oh, welcome back, you beauties. You can tell by my face cramping from smiling so much how happy I am right now. Joining us is the globally renowned a cappella superstar group, The Soil, set to captivate people worldwide with their latest release of their very highly anticipated album titled Reimagined. What does that mean? I cannot wait to find out, but let's first give them a feel-good welcome let's back go. To the Espresso oh, yes. Studio! Oh,
yes.
Pew, 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 pew! Oh, you all look
I love
younger.
Your energy.
Oh, buddy, no, you give me that energy. It's on days like these that I wish Kat was still around so he oh, could man. Sing your intro in because that's what you deserve. You guys have carved a path for your genre in this country. Let's be honest. A cappella, what without you? And I'm sorry to say that to all the other amazing outfits, but you went all in. And of course, you've added a few more gems to this glittering crown. But Lupino, maybe I can start with you, bro. How have you been? Where have you been? Why have you made us wait so long for this masterpiece?
Oh, man, we've been around, you know, and we had to bring out this nice body art of work. But yeah. Before that, we had to find ourselves, you know. And then I know it took long. It took like 7 years to make this product to come out finally. But we had to go to our spiritual journeys and stuff like that. And then we had to come back together and introducing Theo to this new amazing, you know. And then she's just a ball of fun also, you know. And I can't wait for you guys to hear her.
Oh, me too. Listen, I've done some sneaky listening around the sides. And I love the fact that you were once quoted in interviews to saying, I don't know why they picked me. Do you still feel that way? Have you found your place on the board yet?
I really have found my place. You know, at first I was like, I don't think I can do this. The Soil is big, you know, and I had a really big space to fill, you know, but I'm slowly finding my way, and Untsika and Phindo are just making this journey a beautiful and a smooth one for me.
Because it is a journey with you guys.
Yeah.
You know, when we talk about the spiritual connection here, it's not a nice to have paint over afterwards as a marketing gimmick. This is who you are, and you've always represented that.
Yes.
Where on your path are you right now? Why was this the right time to and how privileged must we be that it's taken 7 years to create what I assume is going to be a perfect offering? Not baby, not by your standards, but by ours. But why now?
Yeah, so I personally feel stars aligned. Finally, everything just fell into place. And in the 7 year hiatus, in as much as you feel like it's a privilege for you guys to dish up this music, but it's a privilege for us to share it with the world. Mm. These are our thoughts. These are our way of praying. These are our way of how we also find our family members and just pour into them as well. Those stories that we took from our families in our sacred spaces, they're all lying bare in the album.
Have these stories changed? Because I'm getting goosebumps hearing you talk, but I expect that. And I'm that guy on the set who gets like overly emotional about things, but there are so many threads being woven together here. Yeah. Pino, has it changed? When you do that introspection, when you speak to your people around you, your clique and those that you represent, those that you serve maybe is a better way of putting it.
Yeah.
Is that narrative changed since the last time we plugged into this magic?
I can safely say we've matured enough,
really?
You know. We haven't lost the touch of the soil. And we, for now we are old, we've got kids and stuff like that. We think differently.
You're just getting started, buddy. When you've got kids, it's the reboot, man. Yeah. It's the reboot, and everything matters so much more.
Mm-hmm.
So Reimagined, you got to be a part of the reimagining of the soil. What does that mean to you? And give us some threads here being woven into this album.
Oh, man. This means, obviously, the makeup of the group is now different. It's reimagined. Even the music has been reimagined. It's more spiritual, you know. We talk about love, we talk about spirituality. There's conversations between yourself and God or whatever you believe in, you know. And me being woven up into this journey and this process of making this album was a beautiful one for me. It was hard because it's something that I wasn't used to, you know, and I got to learn how the soil works, and Uphindo and Tsika just took my hands and they were like, let's walk together, we can do this together. And this is where we are now.
You say it like that, but I have a feeling in this day and age, I'm finding more and more I need a younger hand to guide me through this space, because the world has changed. We are surrounded by purpose-driven young people. I'm going to let you three youngsters go and do what you do best and treat us to some exquisite, exquisite music. And of course, we're going to give you all of the details of how you can plug into this incredible opportunity. And I mentioned his name a little bit earlier. Of course, Kat is going to be joining in on that magic, which is amazing, one of the best in the business. But on the 9th of March, you have an opportunity to see them perform live, and it's different every time. There is no one performance repeated ever, and we'll keep those details up on our social media platforms on how you can plug into the soil. Go and sink your toes into the spirituality of the soil, which is an amazing thing, but you don't have to wait too long, because they're going to do it right here in your Feel Good studio.
Oh, well, you know what? Here on your Feel Good studio, we are so excited because the tropical island of treasure, it is back and it is heading to Zanzibar. Now, the celebrities heading to Zanzibar Island of Treasure, of course, are, while Graham joins me, Bobby van Jaarsveld, Umuhle Gela, Chad Jones, Ndavi Nokeri, Carl Kuchelman, Nokobile Kwezi, and Hungani Ndlovu, and of course, our very own Tropica Barbie, Zanele Telwa, who will be hosting this year's season. Now, G-Man, I've got myself a pineapple fresh Tropica. You need yours, so...
Oh, I was about to get slapped. I was about to go like this. There we go. Don't slap me.
There we go.
Thank you, my boy.
So now we all have our drinks. We are ready. And you can also be part of this dazzling cast heading to Zanzibar.
And this is big, lest we forget that you have the opportunity to win your half of R1 million, but you need to audition and audition well to enter. So let's take a look at some of the incredible entries thus far.
Hi, my name is Given. I'm a content creator, influencer, and a dancer. So guys, this is why I want to be in the new season. So I believe I will bring that good energy. I'm super funny, I have great personalities, and I'm a very competitive person, and I love challenges. So what makes me unique is that I have an excellent time management skills, and I am a problem solver, which means I can multitask a lot of things in a short period of time. I'm a jack of all trades, and I believe in winning. So why don't you pick me to be on Tropica Island of Treasure, Zanzibar.
Hey Tropica fam, so my name is Sayla, I'm 23 years old and I am a content creator and also a professional makeup artist. I don't want to hype myself up too much, you know, you gotta like keep your cards close to your chest, but I am physically a very fit person. I love the ocean. I am your girl when it comes to swimming challenges. I will also just bring like good vibes. I've got a good personality. I'm also extremely competitive. We will see what happens. I'm excited to see what the outcome is.
Hi guys, my name is Ki. I'm 24 years old and this is my audition to be on the Tropical Island of Treasure Season 11 competition. I'm a makeup artist, content creator, and a commercial actress, just to name a few. And now, an aspiring Tropical Island of Treasure contestant. And I think I have what it takes to be on the show, because not only am I multi-talented, I'm competitive and I don't back down for anything. Physically, we're prepared, and mentally, we're excited for this competition on Paradise. This is your sign to also audition for the Tropical Island of Treasure competition. This is your chance. Good luck!
She looks like she's on an island.
I was going to say, she flew to Zanzibar to shoot the stuff. I love that. I love the fact that there is confidence. Most importantly, that there is a competitive nature. But let's give you some tips to maybe help your audition go a little smoother, okay? Most importantly, authenticity. Be yourself.
Definitely. You know, if you're quirky, show that in your video. Show off your strengths. Tell us what you'll bring to the island. What's going to set you apart from all of your contestants? And from now until the 4th of April, you can stand a chance to win your share of 25,000 Rand cash.
Nice.
Just by uploading your official hashtag Tropica Island of Treasure Zanzibar audition to social media. Now simply tag at MyTropica and include that hashtag Tropica to stand a chance to win.
Mm-hmm. Well, there's winning opportunities everywhere right now. Remember, the 7 contestants chosen to head actually to Tropica Island of Treasure in Zanzibar will receive 10,000 Rand before even getting to Zanzibar, and that's courtesy of Deep Heat, which they're going to need when running on the beach, on the sand, and swimming so much. It is going to be competitive, but those auditions close on the 5th of May, and they are going to be good if that's the first taste that we are getting. This is your chance to win your share, one half of 1 million rand. Now, that is very, very smooth.
Well, we are taking the quickest of breaks on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. When we get back, it's all about stopping procrastinating and starting improvement today. When it comes to your home, we're going to bring you all the tips you need.
Yeah, the DIY princess is back, baby. I love that. Then we're going to get in the kitchen and whip up something truly scrumptious. It involves bacon. It involves jam. It involves avocado and halloumi. And yes, absolutely bite-sized. Perfect heading into the weekend. And then, of course, the Soil are going to be performing in just a moment. Stick around for that and a whole lot more. We'll see you now.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back as we elevate your lunch game and ditch the post-lunch energy crash with the very versatile Sunbake Vitalife bread range. It's amazing, packed with the fiber that we need to keep you energized and satisfied for a little bit longer. And then, of course, our loaded bacon, jam, avocado, and halloumi roll is a burst of flavor that you simply have to try. And Chef Dre is here to show us how it's done. In fact, I think I'm occupying your station, so we're going to swap around. Dre, you are awesome. Thank you for bringing us these recipes that are accessible, but just exploding. I call it the flavor bazooka.
Lots of flavor in this.
Yeah, so where do we begin?
We're going to start with our bacon jam. So we already have some garlic in here. I think it's onions, actually. And then we're going to add in our bacon. I think we need to up the heat a little.
And I love it. So we've pre-crisped the bacon already, so we're not having to cook it from scratch.
Yeah.
But bacon, I love, because it lends itself to a sweet flavor profile. Yeah. It's the reason why we love our maple with bacon. Mm-hmm. You know, when you caramelize this kind of meat, it just works.
Yeah. So we're going to add some spice to it, and then just mix that in, and then shortly add in our sugar. And then just give it all a good mix. I think we need to up the heat
just a little bit.
Yeah.
Let's see if we can raise the steaks a little bit there. Hopefully that's working. Doesn't want to go up. There we go. I think we are maxing out there.
Okay.
All right. I love that. So, and I suppose it's a process that you don't want to rush because you want to get maximum flavor value out of it.
Exactly. And you want it to be a jam consistency. So this just has to reduce a little bit. So we're just going to add in all the rest of the ingredients and then leave that to simmer
I love Muscovado sugar. In fact, yes. So much that I used to like steal it like a sweet out of my mom's kitchen. And it's not the kind of stuff you use every day, but then on the day when she needed it to actually bake something, I would just hear, "I am!" Then I would leave the house. I would go and hide out in the garden for a little bit just to move past that. So we're going to let that cook down and reduce. Because you do need to make on scale because you're going to make a lot.
You want to make
as many as possible, especially in a studio like this. They will get eaten. Yes. Okay, so while our jam reduces and caramelizes beautifully, we move on to the halloumi.
We're just going to fry this a little bit, just make sure it's golden brown. I just want to get a nice golden color for creamy texture to the sandwiches. And then in the meantime, you can just help me with the avro.
Okay.
Just spicing that up a little bit.
And what are you wanting here? Just some slices?
Yes, please.
And we are blessed to have some of the best avos in the world. I call them green gold because it is such a versatile ingredient to use, but the flavor profile for me, so I'm just going to work off one for now. Yeah. I know everyone has their own avo technique. I sometimes slice in the skin.
And then you scoop it out.
And then just scoop it out.
Yeah.
But for the purposes of this, I'm just going to do a bit of slice and dice. Make sure we've only got the very best bits. But this, for me, why it works so well, the flavor profile is great, the mouthfeel is great, but it's jam-packed with the right kind of fats.
Mm-hmm.
Such a healthy addition.
Yes, especially with these rolls.
Yeah, I love it.
Amazing. So in the meantime, we're just going to also start toasting the rolls as well.
Now, what I'm loving here is we've got crushed wheat, we've got loaded with fiber here, which makes it kind of low GI. So when you're looking for that right kind of energy surge that is going to do you well, this is ideal, taking out a lot of the negative things that we would normally find in a baked good and providing the perfect sounding board for other beautiful flavors, guilt-free, which is massive.
Exactly.
And we've also got the added nice fats of the seeds that are incorporated as well. It's a win-win situation, and I like the fact that the little seeded cocktail rolls are exactly that, cocktail roll size, mm-hmm. so you can do this kind of mezze-style eating.
Yeah.
When you've got this much flavor, you can't overdo it, so you kind of need little doses, and then you go back for more.
Yes.
Love it.
Absolutely. Okay, so this is on the go. Then we can start assembling soon.
I'm just thinking as well, so I'm struggling with getting my kids to eat, and I've realized the most important thing is that they're invested in the process.
Yeah.
So to be able to, every day of the week, we're going to decide, okay, what are we going to have on our cocktail? Oh my word, look at
That's
good. Oh my goodness. Oh, there is nothing quite like a perfectly crusty, beautifully cooked piece of halloumi. That is amazing. So I'm just thinking I can make these little rolls with my kids the night before. They can choose what they're going to put into it, and then they can have that sustained energy throughout because they need a little bit that's going to take them far.
Yeah.
I get that.
And perfect for lunch boxes as well. And the rolls are toasting right now, so
we are winning at life.
Assembling.
Okay, we're gonna switch sides momentarily so I can smell. Oh, that looks absolutely beautiful and amazing. Now, here is the good news, okay? If you think you're winning just with the flavor explosion, the bazooka of flavor, as I said, you also have the added chance of winning one of five Sportsman's Warehouse vouchers valued at 1,000 Rand each. All you have to do is reply to the competition post on the Expresso Facebook, X or Instagram page and tell us this. If you could use the Sunbake Vitalife seeded roll or any of the Sunbake Vitalife breads for the ultimate sandwich, what would you put on your sandwich? Make it good. We're going to get a lot of entries for this one. And don't forget, hashtag Sunbake has to be there. The competition closes 15th of March, but you can find all the T's and C's on expressoshow.com. All right.
I suspect the halloumi is done.
Perfect.
So we're just going to switch that off. That's still reducing.
Our jam can do its thing. Our rolls.
Our rolls are toasting. I think this is fine.
It's absolutely perfect. So while we put the finishing touches on our beautiful little rolls here and then spread the love with the rest of our studio team, you can let your imagination fly free, or you can go straight to expressoshow.com to get the exact ingredients list. But with these beautiful little cocktail rolls, you can take it anywhere. The smells are amazing. This is going to come together beautifully.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to start with our mayo and then.
I'm
taken off of our brand new album, Reimagined. Please enjoy an exquisite song, Malaika.
Malaika. Nakupenda Malaika. Malaika. Nakupenda Malaika. Ningekuoa maliwe, ningekuoa tata. Nashindwa na mali sina we. Nakupenda Malaika,
Malaika.
Yeah.
I did warn you. I did warn you. A spiritual experience. The Soil ain't going nowhere. An incredible performance. And while Dre puts the finishing touches on our gorgeous little cocktail rolls, we're going to eat them in style, yes, and celebrate, continue to celebrate the role of women within our various industry. And in a moment, we're going to take a look at the femmes of the lens. JP Sebastian is very passionate about this one. We cannot wait to see it. And then, of course, it's due day at Builders, and Kath is back to take us through how we can score big. But look at that little baby over there. Dre, you've just created a masterpiece.
Yes.
If you want to try these so gorgeous little cocktail rolls with our bacon jam, our halloumi and avo, go to expressoshow.com. Sunbake, you have knocked this one out of the park. Can you see I'm like a child?
You are ready to go in there.
Okay, let's do it, girl. Yummy! One for you, one for me. Cheers.
Cheers.
Drive juice all over my face. Oh my word.
That's good. It's really good.
This is like honestly one of the best things I've ever eaten in my life. I'm not even joking. I'll see you now. I'm taking one of them. You can make my day.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back. It is your Feel Good Breakfast Show. It's Espresso on S3. And yes, for this Friday, we want to get you inspired because some homes, they deteriorate, gardens get overgrown, and life happens. But today is the day we're going to say enough, not tomorrow, today.
Yeah.
It's time to take action with hashtag DoDay, Builders' brand new platform. And here to tell us more and how DoDay is encouraging customers to stop procrastinating is Vice President of Marketing at MassMart, Catherine Magley. It's so great to have you here.
Thank you so much.
Oh,
it's DoDay.
I'm sitting next to two DoDay ladies. You don't understand. You're both all about action and doing it now. Let's not wait. Let's jump on board. A-type personality here is loving this. A lot of people are sitting at that point of procrastination. DoDay is pushing back. What's this all about?
You know, Graham, it's that morning when you wake up and you look at that garden bed and you say, I can't anymore. Today is the day where I'm taking those dead bushes out and I'm going to builders to get more plants. It's that, you know, that crack in the wall. You go, I can't anymore. I'm going to fix it today. Or the pool, or, you know, painting, or getting a tool to fix something. That's due day. It's the anti-procrastination rallying cry.
Oh. Due day is today.
Due day is today. Now, I love this because I know at MassMart, you guys always come up with the coolest and most fun adverts. In fact, your latest announcement at the Mark Lives advert of the month in February, and it also was recently given an orchid in Biz Community. So we're going to take a quick look at this fantastic ad.
Neighbors, builders, renovators, today we make a stand against ugly, against unfinished. You're scared, I see it. Worried that job you took on was too ambitious. Do more. Are you drilling for oil or hanging pictures? Was disco lime too bold a color for the lounge? Maybe, Janice, but bold is the enemy of boring. And built-in bras don't just build themselves. It's time to turn that pond into a pool, Pete. Today, we take back our homes, our gardens, because today is...
Saturday!
No! It's due day!
There's one in every group. There's one in every group. That is superb. I don't know the team that you used to make that ad. Pay them double next time out. Absolutely amazing. You can thank me later. Incredible. You capture that essence. But of course, now you've got to deliver on that promise. And I always joke, whenever we shoot inside of builders, I always leave with something that I didn't expect to have. And it's not necessarily a special, it's what I need. You get that right. How does builders support us on due day?
So builders has got several levels of support. So, you know, Graham, not all of us are DIYers like Zoe, who
is
a DIYer.
Exactly.
But builders will cater for the, you know, the quintessential
the
DIYer.
Pro, yeah.
But if you're not like me, then there's others to help. So they'll help you get a tiler or get a painter, or, you know, test your pool water so that you can go there and have your own due day, whether you are a DIYer or not. And it's the same with the contractor. There's people on site to give you advice online and in store with delivery, which you need. Because when you are in a due day mode, Graham, you want it now.
You want deliverables. Yeah, I want finite, I want deliverables. And what I love about this is often product, QR code, service. That's all it takes.
Yeah.
It's amazing how quickly you've tied those dots together. Brilliant.
Are there people on your team that are procrastinators? Is that how you guys came up with the concept?
Name and shame, go.
Do you know what I have to say? I mean, Builders is the market leader for a reason. And inside that business and inside the store is the spirit of anti-procrastination.
For sure.
And you called it out earlier, Graham, the team, and I must give credit to Devon Kennedy and Cameron Watson, who are creative people from Accenture Song, who picked up on that and said, let's expand on that anti-procrastination rallying cry for other people. And the people in the store, they do their own due day videos for us. It's just so amazing. And in e-commerce as well. So it's just, it's dripped into the organization and the customer loves it as well.
I think it's manifested from the organization.
Correct.
It's almost like this is the only way you
Spot
could
on.
Do it.
Yeah.
And I've spent time on the inside. I've seen the inner workings and it's mind-blowing. The difference in the way that you guys operate in the markets that you need. It's amazing. Advice, Kath, because you go in, you put these systems to the test yourself. You're very hands-on. How do we as a shopper get the most out of due day?
What's really important is understanding what you want to do. So you can see it in your home, and if you're a contractor, you can see it. You can go to the store, you can go online, and you can say, it's due day for my bathroom.
Ah.
It's due day for my garden. It's due day for painting. It's due day for mending the cracks or building that wall. And you can get all the advice you need, all the material you need, and all the the tools that you need to make it a do day. So that's really what's really, really delivering there for builders.
Yeah, and it's just a visit away. Zoe, it's do day for the news, girl.
You know, can I tell you, I am one of those individuals that probably visit builders once a week because I feel inspired when I walk through down those aisles. I went literally into builders to look for paint and I left with wallpaper and adhesive and went and did my own wall in 2 hours because I just felt so inspired. So I love that do day energy. Will there ever be a deadline or an end date to do day?
No,
it's ongoing.
It's a platform. So it's not a 6 week campaign. It's a platform. It's something that we believe and feel. It's something that we want to do to help South Africans. It's do day in South Africa. It's a higher purpose campaign. You know, it's inside our business. Our customers resonate with it. The market resonates with it, and it will be an ongoing thing. You will see a do day part two coming soon.
Oh, it's all about sequels this year. okay, Zoe, you do have to actually go and do the news. So I'm going to send you on your way in just a moment, but I want you guys not to delay any longer. I want you to head to Builders right now. In fact, don't leave right now, but just now. And you can go and get everything that you need to tackle those tasks. No matter how complicated they seem, just stop procrastinating and take the first step. So let's make today that day that we get things done. It's due day, baby.
Thank you, team. It's time for us to take one final look at your national headlines. The George Airport on the Garden Route of the Western Cape is among 6 airports in the country to be upgraded as part of a nearly 22 billion rand investment plan by the Airports Company of South Africa. The airport handles some 600,000 passengers annually and is at the heart of the district's tourist blooming economy. The infrastructure investment is the largest capital investment by AXA since preparing for the 2010 Soccer World Cup in South Africa. And President Cyril Ramaphosa has labelled the situation in the war-torn Gaza Strip as, and I quote, beyond human contemplation or understanding. His remarks came hours after South Africa petitioned the International Court of Justice to impose fresh emergency measures on Israel over what is described as widespread starvation resulting from its Gaza offensive. Citing the UN Office for the Coordination of Humanitarian Affairs, South Africa said in its application that this, and I quote, is the last opportunity that this court shall have to famine. We move to news beyond our own borders. Zimbabwe's government has condemned the fresh sanctions that the US imposed against the country's president and senior officials on Monday. The US accused President Emmerson Mnangagwa and others on its list of corruption and humanitarian rights abuses. A spokesperson for President Mnangagwa on Wednesday said the accusations were defamatory and a gratuitous slander against Zimbabwe's leaders and people. The Deputy Chief Secretary and President Mnangagwa's communications team demanded that the US promptly lift the illegal coercive measures. And President Joe Biden is to announce that the U.S. military will construct a port in Gaza to bring more humanitarian aid into the territory by sea, senior U.S. officials say. The temporary port will increase the amount of humanitarian assistance to Palestinians by hundreds of additional truckloads per day, but it will not include U.S. troops on the ground in Gaza. The United Nations has warned that a quarter of the population of Gaza is on the brink of famine. And just picture this, the more colossal footprints in the Knysna Forest. No, that's not a mere fantasy. Recent findings from a Sanpark study hint at the potential of resettling more elephants in the Garden Route's Knysna Forest in the Western Cape. Collaborating with scientists and stakeholders, Sanparks carefully weighs the recommendations. The study aligns with the sighting of an elephant cow in the Knysna Forest. Yet stakeholders advocating for resettlement, recognizing its ecological, historical and cultural significance, voice concerns about commercial interests. Experts stress the need to a meticulous management approach involving elephant specialists, landowners and conservation authorities before any relocation. Still, wouldn't it be marvelous to witness more of these majestic animals roaming the Knysna forest once more? Well, those are the questions we are asking. That's your morning headlines. Here's a final look at your sport.
Thank you so much, Zoe. Let's start with some footballing news from Europe. Last night, Liverpool delivering a commanding performance, thrashing Sparta Prague 5-1 in just the first leg of the Europa League last 16 tie. An early penalty by Alexi McAllister then set the tone. That was followed by a Darwin Nunez double and then a goal from Luis Diaz. And despite Sparta's consolation goal and a VAR ruling out Mohamed Salah's effort, Dominic Szoboszlai's added fifth goal in injury time, sealing the deal there. So Liverpool now holding a commanding advantage heading into that second leg. Now we turn to rugby, and Ireland are aiming for a grand slam as they welcome back Hugo Keenan for tomorrow's Six Nations showdown with England at Twickenham. It's the big one. And the world-class fullback, fit again after a knee issue, comes in to replace Kieran Frawley in that starting 15. However, Ireland will be missing lock James Ryan, who's been one of their impact players, and that's for the remainder of the tournament due to a freak bicep injury suffered in training. So Ryan's absence extending to next week's finale against Scotland, but I think tomorrow's game, the decider in effect. Now let's turn to cricket, and they continued their dominance on the opening day for India in that fifth test against the UK. So Kuldeep Yadav's 5-wicket haul helping bundle England out for just 218 in their first innings. Yadav's figures are 5 for 72, supported by Ravi Chandran Ashwin's 4 wickets in his 100th test. Nice way to mark the milestone that saw India dismissing the visitors in just over 57 overs. And then a step-in skipper Rohit Sharma with 52 and Shubman Gill with 26. They were unbeaten at stumps yesterday. India reaching 135 for 1 at the picturesque Dharamsala Stadium, where they'll pick up the action, I think, in a moment or two, in fact, with England trailing by 83 runs. And then finally, oh, his name is still in the headlines, and we love it. Fernando Alonso of Aston Martin topped yesterday's floodlit second practice session for the Saudi Arabian Grand Prix, following Max Verstappen's earlier pace-setting performance. So Mercedes' George Russell also in the picture, securing second, trailing Alonso by 0.230 seconds. And then Verstappen settling for third on the grid, 0.331 seconds behind Alonso. The practice sessions took place at the incredible Jeddah's Corniche Circuit. So picturesque, with the race being held a day earlier than usual to coincide with the start of Ramadan on Sunday night, which is obviously a great move amid a record 24 race season. They are packing it in, and as the fans, we are here for that. But that's where we leave our sport for this Friday morning. Let's take one last look at the roads.
Thanks, G-Man. We'll start off with traffic in Benoni, Johannesburg. There's congestion on the N12 westbound at Tom Jones Road. Expect delays and allow more travel time. In Oxford, in East London, there's heavy congestion on Oxford Street, East London, and that's due to load shedding, so allow for added travel time and please maintain a safe following distance. That's your traffic update. Here's a final look at your weather. And the SA Weather Service has issued a yellow level 2 warning for severe thunderstorms. Strong damaging wind and heavy downpours expected to cause damage to property, blowing off of roofs, as well as flooding of susceptible roads in the western bushveld of Limpopo in the early morning. Disaster teams in all KwaZulu-Natal municipalities will likely be affected by the severe thunderstorms. They are on high alert. And the Weather Service has also warned of extreme high fire danger conditions over the central parts of both the Free State and the Northern Cape. And lastly, a heat wave with persistent high temperatures that is expected in places over the escarpment and low veld of Limpopo until tomorrow. Hot and humid weather will result in extremely uncomfortable conditions in places over Limpopo and the low veld of Mpumalanga. To finish off our morning, we have one final look to take a look of our sunrise views. Joanne from Perth in Australia shared her morning view with us. Well, it's probably afternoon there for you, but thank you for that. If you would love to share your morning view, do so on 063-408-8863. Here's a final look at your temperatures for today. Thank you.
a smattering of rain in places, and yes, a couple of warnings to be aware of in that case, but let's see the lighter side and make it rain lots of cash this March. Yes, the cheese shall flow on this show. Now, I have to mention it. Why? Because there is over 110 million rand in total guaranteed jackpots on offer this weekend. So let's start with playing Powerball for a guaranteed 70 million rand, then Daily Lotto for a guaranteed 750,000 rand just today. Then the excitement doesn't stop there. You can play Lotto for a guaranteed 40 million rand tomorrow. That's a jackpot of over 110 million rand waiting to be won by you. As always, you've got to play to actually win it. So how do you get your tickets? You can buy them in store. You can go to nationallottery.co.za online. Their mobile app is brilliant. You can use your own cell phone banking app, or you can simply dial *120*7529# for the USSD. And we'll keep all of those details up on our social media pages, so you've got no excuses. Just please put yourself in the running to win the millions. In fact, a life-changing 110 million rand in total guaranteed Powerball, Daily Lotto and Lotto jackpots to be won this weekend. Will it be you? Well, pound a push or play to find out. Oh, and then we are feeling like winners today. Of course, we've got TikToker Spokhutle stepping into studio to talk about her meteoric rise. 4.5 million followers on the platform. Mind-blowing. And then we're going to celebrate some incredible woman being International Women's Day. We're going to take a special look through a different lens at the femmes of the lens. JP Sebastian takes us through that one.
For Tropical Island of Treasure. Are you? Did you just swim here from South Africa? There's an easier way to find fame and your share of a smooth million rand fortune. Simply upload your audition to social media, explain why you're a match for our celebs. Add the hashtag Tropica and tag at MyTropica, and we could see you in Zanzibar. Buy a Tropica now and enter to be on the island.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
It is your feel-good breakfast show right here on S3. It's all about feeling good, honey. And this is why today we are getting you into the mood for your weekend. And one of the best ways is with the guests that we have got. I am talking about someone today who genuinely just, she takes it all the way to the top when we are talking about not just social media, but absolutely everything she touches, because it will in fact turn to gold. TikTok is one of the biggest social media platforms in the world, where it has over 1 billion users. And one in South Africa, who's part of pretty much watch the top 10 biggest creators in the country. She has over 4.5 million followers, and she continues to be a successful digital content creator and a whole lot more. Everybody, please welcome to the beautiful couch here at the Johannesburg studio, Sibongile. I'm fangirling.
I cannot believe you're introducing me saying all these things. Please.
It's true. Girl, how are you?
I'm good, thanks. How are you? I'm starting my morning being interviewed by my favorite TV presenter.
Stop! So, I'm starting it with my favorite TikToker, so hello. And Sibongile, it's so beautiful to see what you've done, dude. Like, it's just great because I feel like you didn't just do what you're doing on TikTok, but you're doing it on every platform as well. Now you're on billboards and all these things. But let's take it from the beginning, because of course you started out by going into dance on TikTok. Yes. Why did you specifically choose dance and why TikTok?
Well, I started in 2019 and I was just bored in my room. I just finished my exams. I was like, let me try this out. I didn't think that it would lead to me having an interview at 8 a.m. on SABC3 with Zanele Botella. And I did dance because I just grew up loving how to dance. There was this girl, Ekasi, who would like who formed like a group of us and we just all danced and people just look at us. But yeah, I just love dancing. And that's why I chose that.
I didn't know that about you. I didn't know that like you were in a girl group busy dancing.
I was in a girl group.
Sorry, Pussycat Dolls, okay. But babes, you've got over 4.5 million followers now.
Yes.
You have like a million on Instagram. When it comes to that, you know, how long did it take you to get to that point? Because it's not easy. Yes. And more than that, how did you get there? Why do you think it is that, you know, you're able to get so many people who are like, I want to follow Sibongile?
I think just being authentic and staying true and genuine to myself. Obviously, also consistency. I think, I don't know why people love, why do you guys love me?
Girl, you're a vibe.
That's what people say. But I think that's why, I think maybe because of my energy, the energy that I exude and the things that I post on social media. I'm just all for positivity and vibrant vibes. So I think maybe that's why people resonate with me.
And you know, we're looking for that because life is tough, man. Life
you just want to smile.
Exactly. You know? And you make us smile.
I love smiling.
Even your smile just makes us smile. But let's talk about this, because I also know that when we talk about you, you're one of the people who has genuinely taken social media and you've made it something that is big. Like I said, you're on billboards now. You've had cameos and TV productions. How many doors, or not even rather, how many doors? What are some of the highlights in terms of what social media has done for you to open doors for you?
In terms of the doors that it has opened, every single thing that I'm doing was, it all started on the platform, honestly. And when this opportunity opens, it opens another one, and it's just like a domino effect. So it just keeps getting better and better, and I'm just on the road to my, you know, my dreams.
And what are those? What are those, actually, Sibongile?
Being right now, on the TV screens, I wanna be an actress. I've always wanted to be an actress. And it's funny how God is, like, leading and, like, paving the way to that through TikTok. And I didn't know it was going to do that.
And even before you got to, like, TikTok and everything, what were your plans, you know? With you saying you always wanted to be an actress, did you always want to be in the entertainment space 100%?
100%. I didn't know about influencing when I was in high school, but I wanted to be an actress. That is what I wanted to be. I wanted to be famous. I used to tell my friends, like, girl, if you do this for me, I'm gonna bring you along to my first red carpet. And I tried to call that friend of mine to bring her to the red carpet, my first red carpet, and she wasn't available, which is sad. But I still got you, girl.
There are many red carpets to come. You asked for me at the end of the day. Babe, happy International Women's Day.
Happy International Women's Day.
And thank you so much for coming and celebrating with us. I feel like you are exactly what we need when we talk about young people who are not just pushing the margin, but who also represent what young people should be looking up to when they're like, I want to be something in this world.
Girl, so are you. I look up to you.
Stop it. I look up to you. Oh, my goodness. Her name is Sibongile, and genuinely and truly, she is someone who is going to take it all the way to the top. She is someone to not just watch, but someone who genuinely is already doing the absolute most in the content creator space and in the entertainment industry. Right about now, though, you need to stick around because your Feel Good Breakfast show continues right here on S3.
Right, so from the smaller lens to the bigger lens, in fact, the biggest lens of all, it's time to take a look at the femmes of the lens with JP Sebastian. In honour of International Women's Day, we're going to cast a light towards ourselves in the industry at the DOPs that are making waves within the film industry, whose names we don't know.
DOP stands for Director of Photography. That's
there we
right.
Go. The person who takes the shots.
Sure. And so, you know, you can, average person who maybe watches 10 films a month can name maybe one male cinematographer. If you're a film fundi, you can name 10. Even film fundis can't name sometimes one female cinematographer. And they are out there, and just not enough risks are taken on other human beings.
On this asset.
So I want to showcase five of them for you who have touched me and who have done some exciting stuff that intrigued me in the past. And the first one is Maryse Alberti. She is French and she's done this for 30 years. There she is with Ryan Coogler. Ryan Coogler, Creed, Black Panther, Fruitvale Station, and Creed knocked my socks off for its cinematography. I ridiculously could have said that it could have gone toe-to-toe with Raging Bull, Robert De Niro, Martin Scorsese back in the day. Creed was instantly a classic, and for me it was that scene, I don't know if you guys remember from that movie, where it's a one take of two rounds, so that's 6 minutes that the camera doesn't cut, and weaves around the boxing ring like the serpentine movement. Almost. Yeah. What you're looking at is basically a third fighter who's choreographing with the other two fighters.
For sure.
She had this challenge, however, of having to focus on the emotions of that scene as well. You can't just show the punches and whatever.
Yeah.
So she's like keeping the face in its most interesting parts, in its most interesting beats in frame. And there, Mickey Rourke, she also did The Wrestler with Darren Aronofsky. And good grief, she did camera operation on Paris is Burning, the old documentary from back in the day about original ladies and gents and in-betweens Vogue. And she's an interesting person in that she's got her history in documentary, so that's where she gets that very real life, what they refer to cinema verite feel. Creed feels a lot more lived even than Rocky.
For sure. I love that. Great. Others. Yeah, she's got it down. Let's move on.
Autumn Durald Ocupor is the next one who I'd recommend, and I want to talk about people who did recent stuff. So like Creed is recent. So like Wakanda Forever is recent. Again, Ryan Coogler, and sorry, this is how recent it is. I could only get this lady in a mask, Autumn Durald Ocupor. Ryan Coogler, good for him. People say, oh, I'm an ally, I support women. It's like, do you employ them?
Yeah,
and
Stepper,
so this is the third cinematographer that he has employed who is female. The previous one was Rachel Morrison. Wakanda Forever struck me as possibly game-changing for superhero movies just in its visuals. It really felt like they were upping the bar. And the lady is talented. She's from an indie scene, and why that helps is because she had to sort of tightrope this weird walk between doing a superhero movie, but at the same time something that was very intimate because of Chadwick Boseman.
Because of how much it meant, not just to the cast, but to the fans.
So she does these amazingly cinematic things, but at the same time it was something that was quite tender and quite intimate a lot of the time, and she has a bright future ahead of her, a lot younger than some of the others on this list, and hopefully...
You just think of what debt of gratitude directors owe the DOP.
DOPs are sometimes second like director. DOP, sometimes the director is going to the cinematographers again. Is this all right?
Can we? For sure.
And so
who's
another
next?
One who people might look to for that is Charlotta Bruce Christensen, who is from Denmark, but has her name on... I mean, look who she's standing next to there.
Wow.
Denzel Washington for Fences. A Quiet Place is the one that stands out for me.
Oh, yes.
Now, it's, think about a movie where people aren't allowed to talk. So who is the voice? The voice is Charlotte. And so she is basically narrated through the whole thing. And she says, interestingly, there that this is less about Quiet Place, about framing, less about geometry, and more about knowing when to have the right motion for the editor to make the scary cut. The jump scare will happen.
The inertia, the movement that you've got to feel
and
when
so
you're looking.
And so she was a lot more obsessed then with that inertia and that movement than just, okay, this is how to make a scene pretty or iconic, but at the same time doing something that felt like a family drama as well.
Yeah.
And so, like I said already, with Denzel Washington, these are big names. And then far from the madding crowd was Thomas Vinterberg, who also did The Hunt, which I highly recommend. But this lady's also had a name over a bunch of other stuff. And let's make these household names, guys. I mean, even though it's a long name to say, Charlotta Bruce Christensen.
It's worth remembering. It is worth remembering.
You promised us four, right?
I'll we've give you a fifth three. If I even can.
We've gone through three. We've got one more lady.
Okay, and this lady. Oh, man, I've even forgotten my own list.
Claire Maton.
Right, no, actually, you said it the right the first time. Claire Maton, guys, I don't even need to tell you too much on this, but Portrait of a Lady on Fire. This incredible. Good grief. Shot in 8K, actually. What we're looking at here is Spencer. Spencer was obviously Kristen Stewart playing Diana Spencer. And so she was working there with Pablo Lorraine, who has a style that's very much like, how do I get the look that is from the age? I want this thing to look like VHS. I want this thing to look like, you know, old school or something like that. And so she does these wides that are really close and thus gives you this interesting sculpture and these sharp sort of shadows at times when they're just needed. But she has this amazing eye for making things like, please, I'm begging you guys, watch Portrait of a Lady on Fire. Every shot you can hang up on your wall. Look at this.
These are pictures. I was about to say exactly that. These look like still frame pictures.
And when you're doing a movie that's partly about sneaking shots of women so that you can secretly paint them, which is the premise of this movie, this is what everything is, yeah, a celebration of women that Portrait of a Lady on Fire is, and of liberating women that this movie does. Guys, even in the construction of light inside the eyeballs, you know, catch light, when you see that glinting
for sure,
in the eye,
the
even that has structure and architecture. Yeah. But look, there's still so much more to talk about. Women in 2024 is what my next is going to be on. That was the ladies who are behind the lens. Cinematographers, really important. Know some of these names. And yeah, I'll
get we back will to definitely them. Take wow. note of some of these names. JP, thank you for bringing this to the forefront.
Peace, peace.
Stand a chance to win a year's tuition bursary with Stadio Higher Education. If you've matriculated but haven't secured a place to study or want to make this the year of your career growth,
well then WhatsApp the word Stadio to 068-565-4114 and tell us what you'll do once you achieve the degree of your dreams and study with Stadio.
A new vision in higher education. Competition runs 4 to 15 March. T's and C's apply.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back. It is your feel-good breakfast show, and we are celebrating International Women's Day on your feel-good breakfast show. JP Sebastian, he's here. Earlier we spoke about female photographers, and now we're putting the spotlight on movies coming out in 2024 that are directed by females.
Stuff to look forward to. So I was going to cover 2023, but you know, a lot of those ideally should be at the Oscars already. You've got Barbie, obviously, that swept it for Greta Gerwig, Anatomy of a Fall, etc., etc. Past Lives, which didn't get enough acclaim from the Oscars, and it's amazing, by that's Greta Lee and I've forgotten the director's name, but we're talking about 2024 now. We shouldn't forget these names. Suncoast, starring Woody Harrelson, will be one of the most recognizable names in that. And this is going to a streamer in the United States. Unfortunately, we don't have here, so we still might get a big screening of it. Sometimes not everything needs to be fireworks, and if you can just like foster a very intimate again and very like warm sort of journey and environment for your characters, then something like this could be interesting. JP's been very obtuse about a pretty straightforward story. So the young lady is taking care of her brother who is disabled.
Okay.
And it feels like, I really sort of appreciate these stories because I've known people who've had to be carers and it's not an easy walk.
No. Especially at that so young, which is kind of a South African
when
narrative.
You think that you'd be taking care of your life, you think that you'd be on your journey, but you have to possibly say the horrible seeming words like, you know, I feel burdened or something like that. So Woody Harrelson is this character that she hits off the strange friendship with because he's this activist and she also has these inclinations, while her mother is also a very gigantic name. I think it's Laura
Linney. Laura Linney. Wow.
I was just speaking of Truman Show, you and me earlier.
Yeah, exactly.
And so, yeah, I look forward to this one. There's no date in SA for it just yet. And yeah, I suppose if you like these warm, sort of like pokey Juno type things, then maybe this is the kind of thing up your alley. And especially since, like I think, like I said, those sort of stories to me are really important, that you allow a carrot to go, this is hard.
Mm. Yeah.
Like, you don't have to be a superhero at all times.
And it never stops. And I think that's it's quite a story to plug into. Love, Lies, Bleeding. Kristen Stewart steps in again. Yeah,
we just mentioned Spencer. And this lady has done so well for herself since she had to deal with vampires back in the day. Twilight, obviously. Everything she does thereafter is like very deeply considered. She's quite a soulful kind of person in acting. And Love, Lies, Bleeding is fortunately a bit more edgy than something like Spencer, which was beautiful and I do highly recommend. But it feels like a Bonnie and Clyde situation, or I suppose Bonnie and Bonnie. Oh, gross. That was Ed Harris with creepy hair. Ed Harris is a man from her past, specifically her father, who is a criminal figure who she fixes to get revenge on because of this abusive relationship that she's had in the past, and strikes off a romance with this bodybuilder in what, like I said, feels like a Bonnie and Clyde situation. Mm. So if there are a couple of these that have been coming out recently, to, you know, criminal heists and all that kind of thing, taking this last chance, this gap, to write history for ourselves, write our own destinies. And these stories definitely are popular for
I'm here for Ed Harris's hair. That you could have begun and ended there. It does look full on and dark.
I think this is Studio A24, and they carried stuff previously like Uncut Gems. So edgy is definitely the word. Intense. A thriller of A, outrunning the police, B, outrunning this deeply violent human being, and C, discovering this new aspect of yourself and your sexuality. It should be hecka exciting, and hopefully we get more of that kind of thing, as well as sweet schmaltzy stuff.
Selma and Louise for what?
Oh yes, of course, Selma and Louise. Can I forget?
Moving over to ISS.
And so International Space Station, so really appropriately, Russia and the United States are all hunky-dory high up in the sky. And first name I've got to say here, however, is Ariana DeBose. And Ariana DeBose would have come onto the map for a lot of people with West Side Story, where she stole the show. That was her first movie that Steven Spielberg was just like, you're good, don't worry, you're an actress from now on.
Let's build a film around you.
Last thing she was in was Argyle, which was just terrible to give a lady as talented as herself a side role, but here she takes the lead. And ISS is interesting because while everything, like I said, is hunky-dory between these two nations up in the space station, stuff starts going down on Earth. And World War III kicks off. So now they've got this microcosmic, very claustrophobic situation in tight spaces where they're still trying to be like, guys, we're a scientific mission. We don't care about the politics that are going on down there, until they start getting the phone calls from the government saying, take the station by any means necessary.
Oh, wow.
So now you've got these two. I'm very intrigued. It's been getting sort of middling reviews and people mixed feelings about it, but it hasn't obviously come out in SA just yet. It will come out, and when it does, I'll have more to tell you about it. But I am intrigued, especially for something where it's, you know, like a whodunit in a tight space. And in the compression of space, the pressure cooker that is.
And I think if you had to ask AI to like look at a clickbait headline that would grab everything like this, this potentially weaves a couple of those threads together, right?
Sorry,
now,
crazy. I was crinkling my nose because you said a word that some critics were saying that is problematic, possibly. but AI, but we have to move on now. I think that the final one
crazy
that is moving.
I saw the TV glow.
And it gets weirder and weirder. Again, A24, which is studio specifically for weird. So if you like stuff like Annihilation, it's about as weird as it gets.
I mean, it's weird in the name itself.
When why isn't, you know, introduce a bit more weird into your lives, like a boy named Justice. The actor is Justice Smith. It looks like it might have elements of horror. It isn't specifically just that, though. It is psychedelic. And what these two characters find, the girl tells the boy, remember that show from our childhood? It's like a really obscure, sort of like a Vili Vali type thing or whatever. And he sort of remembers it, but half doesn't. So it's this weird dream sort of middle space of, did this really happen? And they both sort of fall back into having a second look at this thing. And the TV sort of draws them in. I don't know if you have a poltergeist situation, but supposedly it's more of a coming of age and a spooky story
spooky
type
way.
Thing. Yeah. So and that's interesting, man. Like, not everything necessarily needs to be like, you know, oh, the sun is the closest star, whatever it was, that love triangle stuff that teenagers are into. Teenagers also want weird stuff too, and I saw the TV glow might be.
Oh, look, my imagination was at its peak, I think, in my teens, man. That's your superpower. I love that. Go and experience the world through a different lens. And thank you for bringing us the Fem lens in this space. Some incredible female filmmakers that are quite literally guiding the course of the entertainment industry. We need to know their names. And right now, of course, The Soil are about to show us a reimagined version of themselves. They've been the best in their lane for as long as I can remember, and they've gotten even better, and they're about to bring us a spiritual, a magical, a heartfelt, authentic experience right now. It's not just a song, it's a feeling, and it's Thandwa Ndim. This is The Soil.
What do you say after that? But this is truly a light-hearted song that speaks about loving someone fully and loudly. Please enjoy Thandwa Ndim.
Ba 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 ba
I did warn you. I did try to warn you. The Soil reimagined, just as good as they've always been, with it even more added magic. I absolutely love you guys. Thank you so much to The Soil for being with us this morning. We absolutely love you guys. And of course, the show isn't over just yet. We're going to have a little bit of fun stepping back into the kitchen, whipping up a delicious Middle Eastern chicken sub. Ooh, in just a moment.
That sounds amazing. And we're going to sort out the whole family when it comes to denim, so don't go anywhere. We will see you in a bit. Well done to The Soil.
We love you guys so much.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Now, welcome back to your feel-good breakfast show on Espresso. It's S3, and whether you want to make a statement or throw on a basic, denim is your ultimate go-to. With elevated staples for kids and diverse styles for mom and dad, Woolworths buyer Courtney Lillo and stylist Taryn Orpel, they are here to tell us how everyone can feel confidently authentic in their denims. It's great to have both of you here. Thank you for joining. Taryn, I'm going to start off with you because we want kids to feel free. We want them to enjoy themselves and not feel restricted. When it comes to styles for the little ones, what can we expect from ReKids?
Okay, so it's exactly that. We want them to be free and play and not worry about anything restricting them. So Woolworths has a great range of really comfortable, adjustable waistbands. This is the legging version for girls. We also have the relaxed denim, so it says it in the name. It's super easy to wear, it's comfortable. But what I really want to point out with the adjustable waist, sorry, Court, can you hold that for me?
Hold that for you.
On the inside are these sort of adjustable elastics, so you know they can grow up and tighten it up, they can grow into it, so keep it for longer. Great value for money.
I love that because I have friends who've got little ones who the waists are tiny but the legs are long and they just can never get the right combination for their growing bodies.
Pull the elastic and just tie the button where it suits the waist and then there you go.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah, so that's awesome. And then obviously we've got some skinny styles for girls and boys. Boys with a little bit of rip and repair details, which is really fun and cool and edgy. And obviously all of these things paired with the basic tee or a long sleeve tee is really great. This is one of my favorites. It's the cargo pants, little pocket to store your toy, you know, as you're getting along. And then who doesn't love a really sweet denim jacket? So this has got the embroidery badges and a really cool print at the back.
I love the detail because you get to personalize your denim jacket. And there's just something about a denim jacket. It gets better the more you wear it.
Absolutely.
It is a favorite. It's forever piece. It is a staple.
Yes.
Now, Courtney, they always say a diamond's a girl's best friend. But in this case, denims are a girl's best friend when it comes to a good pair of jeans. What are some of those new styles we can look forward to?
So Zoe, I'm a denim fan, girly, it's my best friend. So one of the new styles we can look forward to is this cute little bodycon dress. This will be in stores in the next week or two. Really nice where you can like layer it, have it long, put a jumper on for those cold days coming up.
Wear it with a sneaker, pair it with a cute boot.
Heel for date night, you know, I love that. And then just again, you know, this denim guy that Taryn's wearing as well.
Taryn, stand up, you are modeling.
She is modeling it so well. It's so nice for the coverage, the long arms. And then again, my personal favorite, our flat front culotte. You know, this guy, Zoe, doesn't have the side seam, so it really just holds in the side of your hip bones, which is so great.
And it's so flattering.
So flattering, gives you everything that you need. And then again, just the trending item at the moment is this long maxi skirt with the pin tucks. So perfect for work, lunch dates. You'll be the best styled on the streets.
I love that. I had that on yesterday or earlier
in
the week.
And then just talking about innovation, which is so great for us right now, this is called our Never Fade Black Skinny Jean. So it stays black for longer. It's a perfect skinny, and actually it's up to 35 washes where it'll stay black. So
this is
the item that you need in your wardrobe, and it's got a matching jacket. So again, paired item.
That is the item for the individuals that can't wrap their mind around the wash denim and the holes and the style, and they always ask, why is your knees open?
You know, the little... We've got a few aunties like that.
We all have those aunties. Now, we have got some models because we want to unpack these looks, but not just see it on the railing, but also on the ladies.
Yes, which is always better.
Now, maybe, Taryn, we can start off with you. When it comes to denims, how can men style their denims?
Oh, okay, so for men, let me just show you some of these pieces because it's really exciting. We know we always talk about denim on denim. This is actually a really great chambray fabric. So it's softer. So this is really great for, you know, tucking it into your jeans.
Got that nice loose effect.
Wearing it open.
And also these sort of like spot washes in
you
places.
Need to show the camera that. Okay, yeah, so camera, have a look here. These are the spot washes she's referring to.
In spots. Okay, cool. And then just to talk about, do you want to put that back for you?
Yes, just showing the camera.
Just to talk about some cuts and fits, we have a straight and a regular, which are quite classic. I do love these sort of laser sort of bleached spots
the
in
marks.
The front. Yes. So that's those shapes. Then another really exciting colour is the grey, which I love for winter, but it also works quite well in the sort of warmer months or days. And this is the slim rip and repair jeans for men in the slim cut. And what's great about slim is if you're not too keen on something too clingy, which is a skinny, this is the next best thing. So it just fits just right. And then of course the shacket, you cannot go wrong with something like this. A great layering piece over a t-shirt, over some knitwear. So that's a great favorite of mine.
So to the aunties that didn't hear correctly, that is a shacket.
A shirt jacket. Yes.
It's a shacket. I love it. Now, ladies, come sit down, join me, and maybe Courtney, while we have our models here, Woolworths is all about the difference. What sets these denims apart? But let's bring our models in. We've got the whole family here.
The whole family. Look at them.
I love it.
Denim really is just the moment of the season right now. And as you can see, Woolies is really the denim destination for the entire family. You know, what we've put into our denims is our denims are eco-friendly, made with less water, less chemicals, really just so great for the earth. And as well, in our department, we've really just considered the fits, the wear, the long-lasting durability of a denim. And really, this is the cornerstone of everyone's wardrobe. So.
Yes.
Stunning.
I'm thinking family photo shoot, like everyone in their denim.
How cool.
Rocking it. I love it.
I see it too.
I love that we've got something for the kids. Everything fits incredibly. We've got something for mom. We've got something for dad, the young working woman, the young working man. Something for everyone, like
stunning
you said.
For everyone. And I also just want to point out Danielle's jacket because it's all in the detail and those pin sort of tuck pleating in the front. Love it. And then also just looking at the hems, you don't have to cuff your jeans. He's got one roll. Hamish has got about three. Yeah. And then Jaylee has got a little two-toned hem there as well. So it's all in the details.
It is all in the details. I absolutely love it. Now, the only way you'll be able to see the details is if you head into store or shop these incredible looks on the Woolies app, online or in store, and you can really embody a denim look for the entire family. Like I said, these looks are available in store, online, as well as on the Woolies app.
Ree skinny jeans from only $4.49. Only superior trims and finishes like nickel-free hardware and reinforced seams. The only denim to choose.
Welcome back to the kitchen. One last time, we are here with Dre, yo. I don't know why I always have to sound like I'm cooler than I am when I'm talking to you, but you are so cool in the kitchen. You've brought us kind of elevated food that is accessible at home. So smashed it today. Thank you so much. The flavor combinations have been amazing. I've still got bacon jam all over my face, which is perfectly excusable. But right now we are going to have some fun with a kind of Moroccan or Middle Eastern flavor palette, which I know ticks a lot of people's boxes. So we are going to be making an extension of the sub idea, this time a beautiful chicken sub with a very complex set of flavors going into it. We've got a beautiful olive tapenade and, yes, a bang Middle Eastern flavor profile, which I'm here for. So where do we begin?
Okay, so we're going to start with our marinade for the chicken. So we put some yogurt, and then we're going to add some chamoula seasoning. I don't know if I'm pronouncing it correctly.
Ooh, chamoula, yeah. And I often go with, I mean, this is obviously quite a heady, spicy mix, which does fit that Middle Eastern or Moroccan kind of profile. Very strong flavors that you've got to get the balance right. But this would, like a curry flavor profile would lend itself well to this. There's just something magical. And of course, we're going to round it off with our clover feta. We are using the mixed herbs version, which is exquisite. The perfect mouthfeel as well for something like this. It's not too creamy, but it's got a creaminess. It's got a strong salty flavor, so it can be a great counterbalance.
Okay, so
if you want to make it better, add some feta. I love it. See, now I'm going all gangster again. Come on, man.
I love the vibe. Okay, so I just added some pepper, tomato paste, garlic, as well as some lemon juice, and then we're going to give that a good stir.
And for me, these kind of marinades, I'll often marinate, if I am making a curry, for instance, I'll marinate my chicken in yogurt and that curry flavor profile, not just from the flavor development, but it tenderizes them.
Yes. It would be so tender and juicy when you cook it, and you always want that for chicken especially. So we're just going to add in our chicken and then mix it into the marinade and then let that marinate for at least 30 minutes so we can really get the flavors in there.
And I often find I'll put it back in the fridge with a bit of, like, cling film over it or something like that. Let those fibers, like, get all chilly and contract and draw the enzymes in. Yeah. You don't often get to use the word enzymes when you're baking, but it makes a lot of sense. Okay, should we turn our... I'm going to swap sides with you and quickly turn this guy on. So we are... we have a temperature. There we go.
Okay, perfect. So once that's heating up, we're going to make our tapenade, and you can help me with this one.
With absolute pleasure. Okay.
So just throwing everything in
so
there.
So we've got some fresh basil going in. A tapenade needs your olives, and we're using a beautiful green olive here. I think it's the saltiness of the olive that I love the most, but it has a very distinct flavor that works so well with capers. Look at that. When you talk, I have a salt tooth. Does that make sense? As opposed to a sweet tooth, you know? And so for me, things like capers have that. They've got that, and it's an interesting, almost a singular flavor profile.
100%.
A little bit of olive oil, I assume.
Yes. Some garlic.
Don't be shy with the garlic.
Yes.
All the salt and pepper?
Just a little bit, because we already have the salt from the capers.
Of course, you see. That's why you're... Oh, yeah, my governor.
There we go.
I love it.
Okay, then we're just going to blitz that.
Okay. We're doing quite a small amount here. I would make a lot, put it in a jar, and just give it a shake around.
Yeah.
I think you kind of want a chunkiness. Probably even add just a little tiny drop of moisture, just a little bit of water. I'm going to, but that's already looking absolutely gorgeous.
Amazing.
I'm just going to add Just a touch, just to soften it up. And of course it'll absorb some of that moisture as it goes. But I like the idea of this kind of having a chunky, kind of more rustic look and feel to it.
Yeah.
There we go.
Ooh, that's right.
Oh, look at it go.
That looks really good.
I think that is just about perfect. But of course, we have a finished product over there.
Yeah.
And we're ready to put it all together on our sub. So we've got a gigantic loaf here. And this is just one portion, eh? For one person.
Yeah. No,
I'm joking. You can cut it into slices.
This is all mine. I don't know.
Oh, that smells amazing. Absolutely beautiful. And then, of course, as I said, we are using our clover, our elite clover feta. And we're using with mixed herbs in this case. They've also got a great black pepper variant. Feta with feta. It's as simple as that. But this, for me, the crumbliness, the texture,
mm-hmm.
it's not going to just melt in and become a part of the sauce.
It's going to stand
on its own. So if I would make this in a wrap, for instance, if you want a little less of the bread involved,
exactly.
The feta is the perfect sounding board. Oh, my word. Did I make that myself? I really
did.
Oh, that's exquisite.
Okay.
And I like the fact that you've also toasted off our surfaces of mm-hmm. our breads, of our beautiful little buns, our cocktail buns earlier, because it gives it a bit more backbone
yeah.
for the sauce. Otherwise, yeah. it's going to turn into a soggy mess.
And yeah? no one likes a soggy sandwich at all.
Completely.
Do you want a teaser?
I can.
Sprinkle off.
It's okay. I'm going to do it. Hands are always washed before we enter into this kitchen. For this, I wouldn't go too small with the crumbles.
You want it chunky.
Yeah, you want it chunky so that you get maximum value for flavor and for texture. And it is simple as that. Before I go and wash my hands once again, the crowning glory. Dre, you have been phenomenal today. Thank you so much.
You've
brought us three exquisite recipes. If you want to try any of them, especially our Middle Eastern chicken sub, head over to espressoshow.com and enjoy.
Okay. From salads to snacks, savor the delight. Clover's feta, smooth and creamy, makes every bite just right.
Well, it is Friday and we are taking one quick break. I'm here with the gorgeous ladies because we are rocking our denims from head to toe as we celebrate International Women's Day. Well, we are taking a break when we get back. A Friday is not a Friday without the Espresso Friday dance. So go refill those coffee cups. We'll be right back.
It's time to make it rain, lots of cash this March with over 110 million rand in total guaranteed jackpots this weekend. It is massive.
Definitely. Well, you have to play Powerball for a guaranteed 70 million and Daily Lotto for a guaranteed 750,000 rand today. The excitement doesn't stop there. You can also play Lotto for a guaranteed 40 million this Saturday. That's a combined jackpot of over 110 million rand.
That's a lot of lives changed. But as always, if you want to win, you've got to actually play. And you can get your tickets, as we say repeatedly, in store. You can get them online, nationallottery.co.za, the mobile app, the cell phone banking app that you have, or simply dialing *120*7529# for all the USSD. It couldn't be simpler.
Definitely. We've got all those details on our social media pages to make it easier for you. A life-changing 110 million rand in total guaranteed. Powerball, Daily Lotto and Lotto jackpots are waiting to be won, but you have to ponder, pusher, play.
Oh, man. Well, we're going to ponder, push, or play right now for our Friday dance, baby. It's Urlief by Baba Ya. Take it away.
Mount Everest ain't got...
me. Mount Everest ain't got shit on me. Cause I'm on top of the world. I'm on top of the world. Yeah. Mortgage Dubai ain't got shit on me. You can touch the sky, but you ain't got shit on me. Cause I'm on top of the world. I'm on top of the world. And build it up again. Tell him I burned it down twice just for the fun of it. Tell him so much money I don't know what to do with it. Tell him I don't pick up my phone, ain't knowing what the time. Tell him I got me one gun and an alibi. Tell him so much love that the whole thing feel like a lie. I don't need nobody. I don't need nobody. I don't need nobody. I don't need nobody. I don't need nobody.
Just save me.
International Women's Day, my sister. What an amazing day. Thank you so much. Have an incredible weekend. Show some love and appreciation to the incredible woman in your life. We'll see you Monday.
Mount Everest ain't got on me.
From salads to snacks, savor the delight. Clover's feta, smooth and creamy, makes every bite just right.